Rainbow Casino Studios. It's Frosty, Heidi, and Frank on 95.5 KLOS and KLOS HD1.
Frosty, Heidi, and Frank show. Tuesday. A lot of stuff going on today. Still got the Money on the 20s going on. Got the Metallica song to listen for. Also, got some Comic-Con, San Diego Convention Center, Wednesday through Sunday. Is that tomorrow through Sunday?
Yes.
Tickets, one-day passes. Got to give those away today. Also have some tickets to see Mystery Science Theater 3000 live.
That's back? Really?
Live, yeah.
I haven't seen that for years. He's been brilliant. Yeah. Wow, that'd be awesome.
It's going to be at the Ace Hotel July 23rd. Have four pairs of tickets for that. What are we going to do today? We're going to play Get the Fake Out at some point, maybe at 7 o'clock. Think about this at 7:30. What is overrated? You're like, obviously people love it, and you're like, meh. it's overrated. 8 o'clock, so they've got Metallica Song of the Day. I haven't the Biggest Loser in a while. I got some losers in the news. Right. We'll play Biggest Loser at 8 o'clock. But when we come back, I want to discuss, is it a crime?
Are you in trouble?
No. But I don't think this guy should be in trouble either. Because he, I mean...
What did he do?
Well...
Oh, boy.
Involved a bank.
Well, yes, it's probably a crime.
Looks like you can't joke at the airport and you can't wear a ski mask at the bank, right?
Unless
you're in Aspen, I think.
If it's winter in Aspen, can I wear a ski mask and goggles into a bank?
Then and only then.
Really? Then and only then?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to discuss, is it a crime after traffic with Lisa May? What's going on, Lisa?
On the 405 freeway, looking at a problem. This update brought to you by Staples. South 405 at the 101. There's a wreck that's made it to the center divider, but a backup already from about Sherman Way. Cars are swerving around some traffic cones in the two mid lanes on the Ventura freeway, the West 101 at Tampa. On the Pasadena freeway, the 110 southbound around Stadium Way, two-car pileup reported in the left lane. There's big delays behind a crash involving injuries on the 71 southbound. It's at Euclid in the left lane. 91 eastbound before the 55, an injury accident there in the fast lane, and a truck went over the side on the 60 eastbound at Grand. They're now waiting for a tow truck to arrive. Should be there in about 15 minutes. Westbound 60, already heavy from Mountain to the 57. Staples has low prices on everything kids need to head back to school. When your kids have what they need, they go back with confidence. Everything they need for less. Staples, it's pro time. That's traffic on 95.5 KLOS.
Are you paying too much for auto insurance? Visit AAA.com/insurance for a free quote and find out how much you could save. Find competitive rates on auto insurance through the Auto Club. Visit AAA.com/insurance today.
Frosty and Heidi here. We're thrilled to tell you about a one-time-only special event at Mike Thompson RV Fountain Valley this weekend.
It's the first ever KLOS Rockin' RV Summer Sale. It's going on this Friday through Sunday. KLOS daily specials only for this event.
Reduced prices everywhere. We'll be at Mike Thompson this weekend helping you pick out your new RV.
So join us. Frosty's going to be there from 11 to 1 p.m. I'm going to be out there from 1 to 3 p.m. Motorhomes, trailers, fifth wheels, toy haulers. They're going to fit your family and your budget.
Mike Thompson RV Fountain Valley 405 between Brookhurst and Euclid, MikeThompson.com.
At The Y, it's about more than sports and working out.
It's about making my community better.
Living a healthier life.
Spending time together as a family.
It's where I go to learn and play after school.
The Y strengthens communities.
By helping kids reach their full potential.
Encouraging healthy living.
And inspiring social responsibility.
Get involved. Find a Y near you. Visit YMCA.net.
Before you hear this, or this, or even this, before you turn a key, step on the gas, and let it rip, before you get up and out and on the road, you have to be fueled by something. Make sure that something is Valero. Valero top-tier certified quality fuel keeps your engine running cleaner, better, and longer. Find a station near you at ValeroCleanGas.com.
Riverside Harley in Huntington Beach. Harley has secured 0% APR financing on all new Harley Davidsons now through Sunday.
That's right.
0% APR on any new Harley at Riverside and Huntington Beach Harley this week. Finance experts on site to help get you approved. Riverside Harley in Huntington Beach Harley has access to the largest inventory in California with over 1,000 Harleys ready for immediate delivery. It's the best time to buy. Get 0% APR on your new Harley Davidson at Riverside Harley in Huntington Beach Harley this week.
Above average credit.
Turner with a fly ball to center field. It's deep. Pollock going back to the wall. He jumps, can't get it. It's a home run. There is nobody hotter than Justin Turner.
Good night, Daddy.
Tuck your little leaguer into bed with a specially made Dodgers pillowcase presented by Hi-Chew. The first 12,000 kids, 14 and under, in attendance on July 23rd when the Dodgers host the Braves at 110 are sure to have sweet dreams when they nod off for the night. For tickets, visit Dodgers.com/promotions.
Go, oh, oh, O'Reilly.
Keep your windows clean and see clearer with Gunk Glass Cleaner. Right now at any one of your 126 Los Angeles area O'Reilly Auto Parts stores, buy one bottle of Gunk Glass Cleaner and get one free. Gunk's ingredients clean glass without leaving a film or residue. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day. Limits apply. See store for details.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
It's buzzing at McDonald's, buzzing with families all sharing happy moments together. That family celebrating their son's promotion, that table, the new city champs, woohoo! Every moment deserves a celebration. That's why there's something for everyone, like chicken McNuggets made with 100% white meat for mom, or world-famous fries that dad loves so much. Happy meals that bring smiles to the kids' faces and a vanilla cone for a sweet treat. Their son just found out he's getting a sister.
Finding great candidates to hire can be, well, like trying to find a needle in a haystack. Sure, you can post your job to some job board, but then all you can do is hope the right person comes along, which is why you should try ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter is different. It doesn't depend on candidates finding you. It finds them. With its powerful technology, ZipRecruiter distributes your job everywhere it needs to be to find the right candidates. In fact, over 80% of jobs on ZipRecruiter get a qualified candidate in just one day. So, while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, only ZipRecruiter finds you what you're looking for. The needle in the haystack.
Used by businesses of all sizes, ZipRecruiter offers the most qualified job candidates with immediate results. And right now, you can try ZipRecruiter free. That's right, free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/rock. That's ZipRecruiter.com/rock for your free trial. ZipRecruiter.com/rock.
If you run your own business, when you're not on the job, you're on the road, in your van. Signs that say detour and do not enter are just plain bad for business. Well, here's a sign that's great for business. It says 0% financing and up to 2 years complimentary scheduled maintenance on Mercedes-Benz Sprinter or Metris vans. Powerful, capable, and affordable. That's Mercedes-Benz van power. With pioneering safety technologies and low total cost of ownership, Mercedes-Benz vans are the right choice for your business. Check out the full lineup of Mercedes-Benz vans starting at just $25,995. 0% financing and up to 2 years complimentary scheduled maintenance. That's van power for all. Mercedes-Benz. Vans. Born to run.
Starting ad price refers to base model Metris worker cargo van. Excludes all options, taxes, title, registration, transportation charge, and dealer prep fee. Please see your dealer or go to mvvans.com for further details and exclusions.
100% Frosty, Heidi, and Frank.
0% interruption for the next 40 minutes.
On 95.5 KLOS.
Frosty, Heidi, and Frank show. It's got a text already. People are texting the program. If you'd like to do that, you can text FHF and then your comment to 68683. It's about traffic, at least. It says the accident on the 91 is on the westbound side. Motorcyclist down between the 55 fast track and the number one lane. He is moving, just waiting for the EMS.
Okay, good. Always appreciate that.
Takes a village, people.
Accidentist, call lawyer.
444-444-444.
No, call Sweet James, you idiots.
Of course, call Sweet James.
That's what I mean. Take care of the clients. Anywho.
In a weird situation, so was I. Bye.
Not Sour Jim, remember. Sweet James.
Sweet James. Is it a crime? This guy, he went to the credit union in West, as Lisa would say, Des Moines, Iowa.
When did I ever say that?
I know you never have. You never have. Never would. It's Des Moines. Des Moines, Iowa. Around 8:15 a.m. last Wednesday, I'll put this in the quotes finger quotes.
Yes.
Rob the place.
Okay.
But that, okay.
Well, his intent was to rob. Got it. So he's a bad guy so far.
Wasn't?
Well, you said he was.
Well, that's what the story says. It has robbed the place, but that's why I'm saying, I'll get to why I think, is it a crime?
Okay.
He had a hoodie covering his head, going to the bank.
Right.
Anything wrong yet?
He's concealing his face, so that's suspicious.
Well, no, a hoodie doesn't. The hoodie just hides your ears and hair.
Yeah, okay, he's partially concealing
his face.
Unless
it's cold outside.
That's fine.
This happened recently.
Hoodie to the bank, Wednesday.
It's hot everywhere.
It's July 18th.
It wouldn't like 100 degrees all through the Midwest?
It's hot.
Okay. Yeah, the planes are pretty warm in the summer.
So now it's getting in the realm of suspicious. It's okay, but it's suspicious, right?
Okay, maybe you can feel suspicious, okay?
Right.
Take your hat off.
You're in a bank. I mean, a bank's sort of a different place.
In the bank. He was going to the bank.
In a hoodie.
Got it. He was wearing sunglasses as well.
Sunglasses and a hoodie?
Covering his eyes. Sunglasses and a hoodie.
See?
Unless he's on the way to World Championship Poker game. This isn't making any sense.
Of course, it's bright sun outside. It's okay to wear sunglasses.
The sunglasses are fine.
But when you're near the bank entrance, that stuff's got to come off, I think.
Yeah. Really? You think so?
I really do. And why wouldn't it? Why do you need to wear sunglasses inside and a hoodie inside?
He wasn't inside the bank.
Okay, I know.
So he had a hoodie on, sunglasses on. He's outside the bank.
He's fine outside the bank.
He's in the parking
lot.
That's fine.
That's fine out there. But he's going near the bank, isn't he?
So you can't walk near a bank with a hoodie on and sunglasses.
Near the bank. But when you start getting close to the door of the bank.
You hit the steps of the bank.
When your hand's on the door handle, you're opening the door to the bank. That's when the disguises have to come off.
All right. Remember that statement right there.
You got to see your face.
Not that one. The one before that one. Okay. You said when you're standing there and you have your hand on the handle and you're opening the door to the bank. That's what you said.
Yeah, because you're crossing the threshold of the bank, and there's security cameras aimed right there.
Right.
They need to see who's coming in the bank.
Right.
Okay.
So remember
there.
What Frosty said right there.
Got it. Okay.
Oh, he also had a red bandana covering his face.
Oh, for God's sakes. Now we have a bandana and sunglasses and a hoodie.
Maybe he just got off his motorcycle.
Doesn't say what he rode or
dusty,
drove to the bank.
And he had a.
I can excuse sunglasses or hoodie, but sunglasses plus hoodie plus bandana, that is a disguise, my friend. Nobody walks around like that.
The bandana bandit is what I would call him.
Right.
Yeah.
That's what you'd call him?
Uh-huh.
It's a very Old West disguise, the red bandana.
Yeah.
Okay, in 1882, yes, in Des Moines.
There's just one problem here, and that's where I'm getting at. Is it a crime? Frosty's already got the guy in jail because he grabbed the handle and he's opening the door to the bank wearing a red bandana on his face, sunglasses, and a hoodie.
He looks suspicious.
There's just one problem, though. The bank didn't open until 11 a.m., and this was early in the morning. It's 8:15 a.m., remember the first part of the story.
He's not a good planner.
So, 8:15 a.m., he has hoodie, sunglasses, red bandana on. He goes up to the bank, and the door doesn't open.
Okay.
So he stands there for a minute trying to open the door. And obviously, the bank door's locked, and he wasn't going to bust through. So he gets back into his car and leaves. Now, where does he go? He goes to another bank. Half hour later, he went to the First National Bank about a mile away and tried to rob.
He visited.
Them. They were also closed till 9 a.m. So the guy gave up. I mean, he didn't go back to the credit union, didn't stick around for half an hour to rob the First National. He gave up on his mission and disappeared. And the cops are trying to track him down. What did he do?
Oh, gosh.
Is it a crime? Did he rob a bank?
No.
He wore sunglasses, hoodie, and a bandana. You said in that statement, I said, remember, as he's opening the door to the bank, he never got the door open because it was closed. It's closed. I can wear whatever I want to a closed bank.
You're absolutely right, Frank.
I can wear a clown costume to a closed bank.
I'm with you on this.
I can wear a dead president's mask to a closed bank.
He didn't do anything wrong because his foot did not cross the threshold of the bank.
They're looking
for
him.
They can look all they want, but they can't charge him with anything.
Rob the bank.
They can't charge him.
Put it in a realm. I'm trying to think. I've put myself in a situation where I would think it's a crime, where I have security cameras at my house. Now, if I have a guy that's dressed as a ne'er-do-well, and he's got a gun, and he's come to kill me, or so it looks like, he's got a gun, he's looking in, but he can't get in. All the doors are locked, but he's got a gun, and he's looking, and then he leaves. Yes, I want police to go look for that guy. Yes, of course I do.
In this particular case, you said the gun was on camera. Well, because he's carrying a gun, guy was just trying to open a door.
Yeah,
difference
between gun and bandana and sunglasses and hoodie, Heidi. The gun means you're up to no
crime.
Good.
This guy was just trying to open the door to a closed bank.
The guy with the gun can't make an argument that it's going to excuse his behavior. The guy with the sunglasses can.
If the guy just had on a, you know, a hoodie and sunglasses and a bandana and he was looking over your wall. Well, man, he can't look in your wall, but he's trying to open your gate. And you have a security camera on your gate. You can't get it open.
When
he walks down the sidewalk. Did he commit a crime? No.
So they're looking for the guy. They want the guy. Well, he's not going to turn himself in, for God's sakes, and he's not going to wear the costume again. What are they wanting for? Questioning? Why did you try to go in the bank?
Because in the story, he tried to rob the bank because of the way he was dressed, the way he looks, and I think that's discrimination.
Nah, you're right, Frank. It is discrimination. I'm with you on this. They're not mind readers. This isn't Minority Report. They don't have special insight into what you were about to do or were thinking of doing. He didn't do anything wrong. Now, he might have done something wrong had the bank been open. There's suspicious still, this behavior still there, but he didn't do anything wrong, so you can't charge him. So I call him up from payphone and go, ha, 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 it was me.
But I think anytime.
He ain't going to get me because I didn't do nothing wrong. Click.
But I think when you're if you're dressed like that, you're obviously trying to disguise yourself. And when you're trying to disguise yourself, why do people disguise themselves? Because they don't want to be caught.
Right.
Or, I mean, you know, so caught doing what? If you're
doing nothing. You can say you're wearing a disguise today because you put makeup on.
Yeah, but Frank, I'm recognizable.
No, I'm sorry. You are not recognizable from one to the other. We've seen both.
You see me on Fridays around here where there's no Dish Nation shooting. Who's that lady? Isn't we? I don't know.
I like you more on Friday because I'm used to hanging out with just common, ugly people. that came out wrong. What I mean is.
I understand. I know. I get it.
All right. Chris is on the phone. He wants to weigh in on, is it a crime? Hello, Chris.
Hey, good morning, guys.
So is it a crime to rob a bank that's not open? I mean, he didn't get in.
The thing is, they charge you with intent to commit a crime.
That's crap.
Like if you get pulled over with a bunch of drugs and baggies, they'll give you with intent to sell, even though you didn't sell one thing.
Yes, because the drugs are illegal. Yeah, sunglasses, hoodies, and red bandanas are not illegal. They're just things you put on your face.
And you can't transport. But they hit you with sales, not possession. They'll hit you with sales even if you didn't sell it.
Even if it's all for you.
They'll add that on. I think there's also possession, and then there's with intent to sell because you have so much of it. But you can't be driving around with a trunk full of cocaine. That's against the law, and they stopped you and opened your trunk.
What about weed, though? You could drive around with a bunch of weed, but technically now you still can't sell it.
Right.
Because they give you a certain amount as personal use, right?
Yeah, up to a certain amount of the law says.
And how much is that?
I don't know. Pound or two? Drugs. I don't know. I have
not. Hey, everyone's personal use is different.
I thought you would know. Right. Yeah. I thought you of all people would know that.
Mm-hmm. I mean, if we were buying bags of chips, Frosty's, you know, bag of chips could be way bigger personal use than, say, anyone else's.
Or single serving, It's different for you than the rest.
Yeah, Frosty's picnic size is the family size.
I never buy the small bag. Can we just cut to the chase here? I'm pretty sure the guy was trying to rob the bank.
I'm assuming so,
too. Because that would explain his looks. And he couldn't get in the first one. I'm sure he was trying to rob the second bank. But the problem is, in a court of law, he did not break any laws. He looked suspicious, but he didn't even get into the bank. So you can't prove what you think he was going to do.
He's guilty of being early.
Right. That's it. But thank God in this country, you're innocent until proven guilty. And
he should steal a watch.
Yeah, you should just hire a guy that has a watcher, knows how to Google and go, what time's the bank open? Oh, not till 11. I guess I can relax a little bit.
All right, Chris, I'm going to give you a prize for letting us know why it's intent to rob a bank.
Do you guys have KnotFest?
Do I have KnotFest? Let me see. I do. No, I don't.
Oh, you don't. Oh, yeah.
Oh, I thought I did.
You've been robbed, sir.
Oh, no, wait.
No, he has the intent to give it to you, but.
There was intent to give you that, but I don't.
He's not giving it to you.
Oh, man.
I send you the High and Mighty Festival.
Oh, hell yeah, that'll work.
Sublime with Rome, Dirty Heads, more downtown Garden Grove, August 5th and 6th. You are going, okay?
Thanks. You guys are the best, man. Thank you.
Thank you, Stan Hold.
You can't start locking people up for what you think they were going to do. Let's say elevator.
You're dressed like a whore, Sammy. We could say that she's prostituting herself.
So she's walking down Sunset and Friday
she's
evening.
She's walking down the street out here from this halfway house.
Yeah, out here.
Gosh, when you put it like
and
that,
I pull
it
over
it
and
does...
it's like there's intent to sell that ass.
But there wasn't.
That's different though, Frank.
You ever watch Sammy walk?
But well, yeah. Who
you wonder how she got bow-legged, and you're like, I know how.
It looks like she sold it 5 minutes ago.
She's still tender.
It's like, damn. She doesn't walk really. She's bow-legged, but now she walks like this. She walks like she turns hips first and walks.
I noticed that. She leads with her.
She's so sore.
Yeah. Sammy, you lead with your pelvis in a uh-huh. weird sort of swinging yeah. motion.
Mm-hmm. It's hips first. Like she kind of waddles
she's
forward.
On a swivel.
It's how the cavewomen used to walk.
To keep her genitals so still. You have to yeah. swivel.
She's like a stabilizer.
Because if you walk, they'll rub on each other, and that's just raw.
Right, right. Mm-hmm.
What's that explosive thing that you can't jiggle or explodes?
Oh,
C4? No, nitroglycerin?
That. It's like she's walking with nitroglycerin up her kitty cat. Don't jiggle it.
Easy. You got the hurt locker over there.
Yeah. C4, hell, C9.5, possibly 10.
But can we put it back on Sunset where I know where the hookers are?
Yeah, go
ahead. I know
back
there's,
on
some
Sunset.
There's some in this block as well. But you know, there's that one part of Sunset where you can't even turn left or right for a few blocks because that's where all the hookers are.
Hey, baby, looking for a date.
There you go. Now let's put her, Sammy, out there and dressed like a hooker, standing with the hookers, doing the hooker buffalo stance. And the cars goes by, she's swaying her hips. She's giving all the signs of how much you want, Charlie. Now, there is an intent there because she's doing what...
Well, and she said how much, you know, she's saying she's promoting the product. If she's just walking, dressed like a slut, you
well,
can't assume
fine.
She's trying to sell it. That's what this
fine.
Guy did.
That's fine. But if she's with a bunch of other hookers in Hooker Street...
She might be waiting for her Uber.
What if she has to be walking right by hookers at the time you drive
yeah,
by?
Yeah, bad timing. Sorry.
And then, yeah. So when you put
all right,
like
we got
that,
Taylor on the phone. Taylor is a cop. Let's see what he has to say. Hello, Taylor. Taylor.
Hey, what's going on? How are you, Frank? Frosty.
So is it a crime? Is intent to rob that bank when the bank wasn't open?
Absolutely not. What that guy said, I mean, here's the thing is, you can wear whatever you want, wherever you want.
And that was his race to rob. Oh, sorry.
What?
I was going to say, the problem is that us as Americans automatically think that's going to be odd behavior or that's not something that's ordinary. It's obviously out of the ordinary. However, if you want to walk into a bank wearing that getup, you can still walk up to a teller, make your transaction, and walk out. Is it going to be suspicious? Absolutely.
Yeah, you can, but absolutely, should you? But, if you do that, you know this guard's going to be up, coming and see what you're up to. And someone may tackle you. Some guy behind you in line may tackle you. Some hero. Let's roll. Why risk all that?
Yeah, I was watching My Neighbors Earl the other day. And they walked into a bank, and they were, you know, he had that list where he had to do good things for people. And I guess, you know, he did something to a bank teller. So he's going to the bank, and he has a dozen donuts. And so he goes in with his brother, and he's like, hey, everybody, listen up. Because he was just going to give them all donuts.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody fell on the floor, and the security guard threw him the gun. He's like, oh, no. And puts the donuts down and runs out.
Oh, my God. No.
See? You can't raise your voice in a bank. Hey, everybody, you can't make an announcement in a bank.
Mm-mm.
Even if it's for free donuts.
That's true.
Right, Taylor?
I completely agree. I'm just saying that as the last guy, he's saying that you have some baggies in your car that's intent to sell. Or you walk in, you touch a door handle of a closed bank with a mask on that's intent to commit a crime.
How about this? I have a shovel.
So, Frank, I think you're absolutely right. You could walk in there with a president's mask on for all we care. You didn't do anything.
And if I had a shovel and lie and duct tape in the trunk of my car, doesn't mean I'm... intending to bury someone, does it?
I wouldn't say so.
There you go, Taylor.
There's no way.
But can we just put the rest of the sentence in there? But clearly you are intending to bury someone.
No, it just
but
looks
just,
like that.
You're skirting the law by going, you can't prove it because you can't find the body. But you're clear, why else would you have
judging based
that?
On based on your history, Frank, they probably will think that you're burying somebody.
They probably, thank you so much, Taylor. This is like when you go to the grocery store or a Rite Aid or something like that, and you get certain items, and then the cashier, because the items you got can assume what you're doing with those items, and it can be embarrassing, the odd combinations.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's true.
Like duct tape, cucumber, and fly swatter.
When they're looking for suspects, they see what people have bought at Home Depot and Lowe's. They're looking for the receipts.
I have a fly problem. I'm going to chop up the cucumber tonight and the duct tape. You always need duct tape.
Yeah, you get
the lime.
Your brake light fell off.
No, I didn't put the lime in there.
The lime. He's got a bucket of lime.
That was in the trunk. I'm in a different. I moved on to a cash register.
Different crime. You got to make three trips. Three different.
Buy them at different states, for God's sakes. Buy the lime over here.
The Walgreens for the flux water at Home Depot. I mean, it's more time out of your day, sure. But
all right, so the cop agrees with me. It's not a crime. You can do whatever you want. So the guys in Iowa should not be looking for this guy.
I agree. It's a waste of their time.
Cops in Missouri, a guy was described as, quote, white male with shaved head, tattoo on his neck. And, well, I think I have the call.
Oh, good.
Now, had a stealing white male, shaved head, tattoo on his neck. I seen him heading northbound. Probably stole two dildos and a bottle of lotion.
Oh, my God.
You need two. I mean.
That dispatcher.
I just love
his voice.
Let's just come back real quick and listen to that again. That was fun. All right.
Hey, copy. Show you around. Clerk now advises had a stealing white male, shaved head, tattoo on his neck. I seen heading northbound. Probably stole two dildos and a bottle of lotion.
What is it about his voice?
It's just, I don't know.
It's slimy. Is
Is that a Missouri? So he's got that twang on it.
Dildos
and bottle of lotion.
Oh my God!
Can't you just get into
I think
the
he
guy?
Was trying to think about how to say lube. Mm. On an official call.
Right.
After he said dildos, he's like, I got to clean this up. Can be a professional. Bottle of lotion. Want to hear again?
Yes, please.
Oh, my God. I know. This is
the drop of the day.
Copy. Show you now. Clerk now advises had a stealing white male, shaved head, tattoo on his neck. I seen heading northbound. Probably stole two dildos and a bottle of lotion.
Copy. I'm on scene. Do they have a vehicle description?
He was on foot. They went to the north, and they think went back down the Patriot pawn shop.
Oh, dildos and bottle lotion went to the pawn shop.
Going to pawn them?
How much could I get for this?
He's getting that engagement ring back. He's planning his.
Oh, wow.
I'm confused. I can understand pawning the dildos, but he bought lotion, implying he's going to use them somehow.
You can understand pawning dildos?
Who's going to? They probably
good
give you
punk
money
band
for.
Name.
Did they give you
pawning
money for
dildos?
Uh huh. I'm saying if you're a new band and you're looking and you've been struggling,
there
you're
you
fighting
go.
Over
did
it.
Did
they
give you more if money? Sex pistol works. You know, pawning dildo would.
And you get more if you have lotion with it.
I guess because
I got lotion
you know,
too. It's the lotion.
You need the lotion.
Need the lotion.
Yeah, he, the store manager put it, the guy took, quote, the two biggest dongs I sell. Now, I really wish I had that guy on tape, but I don't.
Yeah,
he stole the two biggest dongs I sell.
I mean, I've been to those stores. Two of them, that'd be rough to be on foot. I've been to those stores. Two of the biggest ones, you're like.
So you're shopping in the big dong section.
No, I don't shop in the big dong. You see
no,
them.
You act like you know
them.
Exactly
no.
what this guy stole,
no, no,
and you
I'm
can't imagine walking
flower.
Out with a big dong.
But
how big
you,
are they?
When you see them and you're like, oh, they kind of go bop, 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 down, smaller, down towards the floor, and you're like, maybe I'm somewhere
you
in the
know
middle
exactly
the...
what rat carries the big dong.
Well,
you know, they go from smallest on the top shelf
you've been to those
all the way to the big, big, giant dongers on the bottom.
You've been to the stores where you look and you're like, that's got to be a party fit. Like, that's got to be a gag. Well,
so you're saying it's difficult to walk with him? Maybe he was using them like riding a horse, like a little, you know.
Or he's using them as crutches.
That's what it was.
Just, I mean.
Crutches. How big was the thing that you saw?
Probably the size of a forearm.
Well, I've seen ones that actually are a forearm.
Yeah, yeah. I mean.
I don't even want to know.
And then they do got the hand either fisted or like in a like a American Sign Language position. Like I don't know what that is.
It's
in American
signing.
I mean, you know sign language. What is this like, in sign language? Like, I put all my four fingers together to form like a snake's head.
Yeah, it's like half of the more sign. Like if you put your two together, it's
oh my God, that's the last thing I want to say when that guy more. What's the fist mean in sign language?
Well, this is an S if you have it like. With the
more
S. In front.
S'mores. Gonna have s'mores tonight, honey? You know what she's getting into with the biggest dongs we sell and some lotion?
That's what I'm picturing.
What does the raised middle finger mean on a dong?
Yeah, those were the biggest dongs this particular place. An 11 inch.
Oh, see? Oh, God.
Well, don't act like it's all small now, Heidi. You said a forearm.
Right. Heidi, are those the ones that are like the both ends are the same, so to speak? How do I word that? They're double-sided.
No, this one was worn as a strap-on. This 11-inch one was worn as a strap-on.
Okay.
Then he stole a regular. This is what I'm so pissed off about. A regular 10-inch. That's regular? When did 10-inch just become regular?
You know, just average, middle of the road.
Sammy used that as a keychain.
They should at least do what Starbucks does, and they call him Venti, Grande,
yeah, right.
Tall.
He also stole a big bottle of lube. They're still trying to track him down. Now, he did steal it.
You look, talk about bowlegged. Look for that guy that's walking funny. I think that's our guy.
I don't know if he smuggled him out. Or no. He just...
Well, if you steal it, how else do you get it out? You stick it in your pants and you walk out.
Yeah, but I'm not going to stick it in my butt.
We stick him one down each
that's
leg.
That's what Heidi was implying, that he was walking funny.
Well, he's probably down his pants legs. Two of them, right? One each leg.
I'd probably wear a puffy jacket.
Oh, well, there's that.
Guys, that's still a big bottle of lube, too. Where am I putting that?
Stick him in my hat? Stick him in the sleeves?
A 10-gallon lube hat?
When someone shakes your hand, you got to put your arm out there, and suddenly that flops out the end.
I'm not sticking it in my sleeve.
Where else do you put it?
In my inner pocket.
Put it in
my
side sleeve.
So it looks like I have, you know.
Or at least put one down the front of your pants, maybe, so it looks like yours, I guess. So you could put one, but two, and then the lube.
Each sleeve and walk out like a river dance with your arms down to your side.
One down each the front of your pants.
And just have people going, I've heard about those guys.
What the hell?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He's got that diphthalic syndrome.
You're right. I saw a Dateline about that once. And
I'd like to have half of one of those. So, yeah, he did commit a crime. Did you ever, when you went to the dong store, Heidi, did you think about stealing something because you were too embarrassed to buy it?
Oh, it's probably, that's a younger person's game. Not as you're older. Like, the older you get, you're like, and you realize everybody working there has seen it all. They don't care. But when you're younger,
don't even gift wrap it.
You have to go like I've done the many times. Like, oh my god, hi, yeah, no, my friend's getting married. She's a bachelor, and you start talking too much. They don't care, but you don't want them to think that you're taking that home. So you're like, oh my friend, she's gonna die.
It is kind of embarrassing though when they come over to you, like you know, like you're like any retail salesman would talk to you about the clothes or can I help you? What sizes do you need? Let me bring like I'm gonna go try it on. But they're right there. It's like, okay, what are you looking for? I don't know, penises.
All right.
So you know, you got a particular color in mind.
Oh, they're worse than car salesman.
You a girthy guy or a lengthy guy?
You just try to do the
feel this one. It feels real. Then you're like feeling some weird dong, looking at somebody else in the eyes, and it's like, does this count as a three-way?
That's when you're like, oh, I'm just browsing. I'll let you know if I.
So if you buy it, everyone else has felt it up. There's germs on it.
Well, I'm not going to buy that one. They usually have the one that's for the store.
Do people take? Can you take things back? Tester. Like you go, oh, you know what? We're going to have a party, and
the one suction cup to the glass counter is the one everybody touches.
So there's no used ones there, right? No one's like brought stuff back for return.
No, it's no return policy. Thank you, Jesus.
And some of that stuff's expensive, so you do get it home, and then you go, wow, my eyes were bigger than my.
Really?
Vagina. Oh, this happened to me.
Really? You went? Oh, this might be nice.
And
were you going?
That's the one I told you.
Were you going for the record or something?
No. It looked totally normal, but I'm very. I'm telling you.
You don't have to.
Do I need to get my doctor in here?
Don't protest too much.
I need to get my doctor in here?
Whatever
I can
that
get
word
a doctor.
She's been told she's very compact. I recall that from your doctor.
So we got this one that was actually really pretty, and I was excited about it and got home.
What's so pretty about it?
It was like silicone, but it was like clear. So it was clear
with
silicone.
Sparkles
and,
in it?
And in the middle, it had like. Black and white kind of striations or
so
stripes.
It was glass.
It wasn't glass. It looked like glass, though. It was really pretty.
Did it bend?
Yeah.
Was it squishy?
Yeah, it was silicone. But if you just looked at it, it looked like glass. So I was like, wow, that one's really pretty. Is that glass? He's like, no, it's a silicone one. I was like, okay, because I'm too afraid of glass.
So if it's glass, it's like you can fantasize you're doing it with the Invisible Man.
Which, I mean, who hasn't fantasized about that? So I got it home.
When Superman does him in the butt. That's a whole different joke. Look it up.
And got home, and it was too much, too buku, as you say. And it made me go numb on my right side. It hit some nerve where I wasn't built the way, and I was like...
You had a stroke?
Yeah. So I was like, oh.
No, that means... Oh, Heidi, oh, my Heidi, that means it's working.
No. That was not a fun feeling. I was like, everything went tingle numb.
A friend of mine said that. Like, she started dating some new guy. She used to go out with a guy she called OB, old balls, because she was this young girl, and he was in his 40s, and so she called him OB. But then she's like, start dating this young guy, and I guess he was, you know, hung like a bear. And she's like, every time he'd do it, my right side of my face would twitch up. Best sex she ever had. You stopped too early.
No.
All right, ladies, 1-800-955-5567. Twitchy face means good,
where
right?
Where I felt like my, like...
Lisa May, you ever had your face twitch up?
No. But I have had someone who I was like, I don't know how you will ever have a girlfriend. I just don't know. Like, this was a one and done. This is ridiculous. Go away.
Yeah, right, there's too, there's
take
too much.
Take that thing and get out of here.
Never call me, lose my number.
Yes.
It's too much.
It's too much.
Would you say there was some comedian, or maybe you even said it, Frank, it's been so long, I can't remember, where it's like, it's so big that it eats baby rabbits. Like, you have to feed it. Like, it's like a thing, a monster. That's too much. No one's looking for that.
We did a video years ago, and you brought one in that was purple and
that
sparkly.
That was supposed to be secret.
Remember that purple sparkly one you brought in?
Yeah, right.
And it was a double-ended, double-sided
thing. Yeah, for carpooling,
thinking,
as they say.
Well, and that was yours. You brought it in. I'm thinking, how in the heck could any woman alive use this thing?
This was for two. Bicycle,
I know,
bill
was,
for two.
It was. I know it was for two, but it was huge, massive. It's like baseball bat.
Because it's built for two.
Right.
But it was like the width of a baseball.
In the middle, we meet.
The width. Like the
little
red
little
one.
Slugger with
the red bat, the little kids need.
A kindergarten bat.
Now, would you be embarrassed buying that in the store? The massive, huge.
Well, yeah. That's when you say you're going
sparkler
to a bachelorette party.
Right. Like, our friends are just going to die. Yeah. This is hilarious.
Somebody we know just got divorced. So we bought her this sparkly baseball bat dong.
You know, to cheer her up.
So, Sammy, you ever had your face twitch yet?
No. Mm. This is the first I'm hearing of that.
You never had one that was too buku.
No, but I think the thing is that if the guy knows how to use what he's working with, you're not going to twitch up. That's what I don't understand. Like, something's wrong if you're twitching up. But, he doesn't know what he's doing.
When you're in the Sammy public pool, there is the 3 foot end, and how big is the diving board at the deep end? You know what I mean? Do you have that three platformer because you can, you know, take some pretty good dives?
How dare
Or are you like, don't dive at this end, you can snap your neck. You know what I mean?
But I think the thing with
Everyone's
Sammy is...
Everyone's got a deep end. It's deeper.
Well, but Sammy's also different because I think she's more elastic than the normal woman. Like,
why would that be?
Look at her cheeks. Pull your cheeks out for the room, at least.
Oh. That's so
it's
great.
It's like Jim Carrey.
So,
stretchy
I think
face.
With that, maybe she's
Her whole
that,
body. She's Elastigirl.
She's whole... Yeah, so she's gonna... I can't do that. So... I'm not that way, so maybe she's that way down there, and you could just, it's not a problem.
Think so, Sammy? You think you're just super stretchy?
I'm not saying it's not a slam. It's like a great
thing. It's kind of a slam, but whatever.
No, being super stretchy is good.
I would say, I guess, kind of, but in terms of, like, it always goes back,
of
if
course.
That makes sense. No, but I'm saying,
it's
like...
It's close
to. No, I know, but it will, like, if I go even just a few days without having sex or something... It's like it closes back up.
Well, yes, of course.
No, but I'm saying it's like...
You've had to go by a day and it didn't?
No.
Like a few days, it finally did? It finally like...
No.
It didn't, Sammy. It whistled when you walked out of the
table. Slap shut.
If it's closed back up like that and someone's just trying to shove something in and they're not
doing anything before
and they're large, then
you like some
you're going to start twitching.
Okay, okay.
Elastigirl. She's a superhero.
See a movie franchise built around Sammy.
No fear, Elastigirl is here.
What's the matter, Eric? You got the look on your face like your mom's listening.
Oh, Sammy makes me nervous when she talks sometimes because it's my job to watch out for the license of this stage.
All right.
Yeah, I think she did pretty good that
time. She did a good job. Good job,
good job, Sammy.
Yeah.
Good job, Sammy.
Because we faded her out just in time. Good job, Sammy.
Her mic is off for the record.
Yeah, exactly. Only we heard that. 1-800-955-5567 is the number. Let's take a quick look at traffic. What's going on, Lisa?
Traffic report is brought to you by Raging Water. Sig alert on the 91 westbound at Lakeview just canceled. The right lane reopened as well as the right lane of the fast track lanes, but there's still slowing as you approach the scene. On the 60, two sig alerts. Eastbound on the 60 past Grand in Diamond Bar, right two lanes are closed. Crews are trying to retrieve a truck that went over the side. That's backed up to the 57. And then in Chino on the 60 westbound at Mountain Avenue, it's an injury accident in the left three lanes, the carpool in the two fast lanes, and traffic is jammed from Vineyard. And on the 5 southbound at First Street in Orange County, a crash has moved to the right shoulder. That's backed up to Brookhurst. Live for summer at Raging Waters Los Angeles, California's largest water park, with more thrills like the first hydromagnetic coaster on the West Coast. Save up to $8 with coupons from SoCal Albertsons and Vons locations. That's traffic on 95.5 KLOS.
Lisa's going to make her way in here and give us some more news of the day. In the meantime, you celebrate your birthday today on July 18th. You celebrate with Kristen Bell. She turns 37 years old today. Also, Vin Diesel They've been diesel is today.
45.
52.
50. Oh. Big 5-0 for Vin.
He looks good.
Ricky Skaggs is 63.
I'm just a country boy. Country boy at heart.
The Ricky Skaggs are the biggest, best mullet in country music next to Billy Ray Cyrus.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Who had a better one, Billy Ray or Ricky Skaggs?
Well, I think Billy Ray is probably more famous.
I think, yeah, Billy Ray, I think, had a better mullet. But I think for combo, Ricky Skaggs had that, like, bouffant. The bouffant really going on in the front.
Right, and then just all party in the back.
Richard Branson, British billionaire behind the Virgin Empire. Martha Reeves is 76, leader of Martha and the Vandellas.
So come on, every guy, grab a girl. Everywhere around the world, they'll be dancing.
You ever see this video with David Bowie? And
yes.
Oh.
Awkward.
They're online on YouTube. We talked about this before. They have it with no music. Where you just see these guys dancing around each other.
Yeah, it's very awkward, very strange.
And you hear their feet. And
it's Mick Jagger and David Bowie.
Right.
Yeah, Mick Jagger and David Bowie. James Brolin, 77. Dion DiMucci, 70.
Don't know who that is.
It's Dion. I keep away from a run around sewer, yeah. My lips and a smile. 78. That's still kicking. Crank it up, Eric. So if you don't want to cry, like Dion I keep away from a run
around sewer. Whoa. Did run around mean like easy slutty back in the day?
Yeah, she's a run around Sue, you know.
She's a run around.
Yeah, don't make her your wife is the
okay.
Is the message.
You don't want her. She's not the cat's pajamas or the bee's knees. No, she's a runaround.
You're going to fall in love with her, right?
This yeah, is, don't make your wife.
Don't make her your wife. Keep, stay away from her.
Right.
Imagine what Lisa was like, probably. Run around Lisa.
No, aww. I was the one you were going to marry. Yeah. Oh, let's
yeah,
be honest.
Yeah, yeah,
that was
she
me.
Was. She
Come
was.
On.
All yeah, right, you
she's a nice girl.
You forgot a birthday.
You really?
Shouldn't forget the birthday.
Oh, and Eric Scott Smith's birthday
Eric!
Today.
Eric!
Oh,
is it? Today.
Wow, you look so young.
Doesn't he look great?
You didn't queue up any of your music, the Paper Heart Band?
You know what? I didn't.
You don't have anything? Maybe next hour.
Everybody in music, it's their music play during the birthday thing, and you didn't play your own music.
You know what? I'll pull up something real quick. I'll find something.
All right, during the news, you pull up something from your band.
And Eric, how old are you? I don't even know.
A lady never tells,
See, he's just mysterious.
Because I've known Eric for a long time. He's not aged, except for the mustache. I mean, you could still be a 16-year-old kid
he's
in
weird.
A movie.
Yeah.
This is. I think you're a warlock. 120 years now, we'll all be gone. He'll still be around looking just like this.
But that's why I didn't make it as an actor, because the same casting directors would see me come in for these 16-year-old roles, and new rounds of 16-year-olds would keep coming, and by round four, they'd go, we know you're at least 29.
That's when you stopped going back.
That was it for me.
All right, Lisa, what's going on in the world?
Listen up, you guys. I have the key word for many on the 20s for today. It is West Covina. Money on the 20s is at 920 when you hear the cue to call. Be caller 20 at 800-955-KLOS. Know that keyword and you will be qualified.
Is there a secret trend to figure out with all the keywords?
Well, I know there's cities.
Yes, that's what it is.
They're all cities. Yeah. Took a while, but we figured that out.
Mystery solved.
And this is pretty cool. Tomorrow, the Frosty, Heidi, and Frank Mike Thompson RV will be heading back up PCH to hang out at Duke's in Malibu for Big Wednesdays, hosted by surf junkie Jeff. From 6 to 10 at the Barefoot Bar, and the first 20 people will receive a pass to see Dunkirk, the epic action thriller that tells about the race against time to rescue 400,000 British and Allied troops trapped by enemy forces on the beaches of Dunkirk in World War II. It's in theaters and IMAX worldwide on Friday, July 21st.
I want to see that.
It looks amazing. Ooh. News of the day brought to you by McDonald's. The GOP has given up on replacing Obamacare after two more senators last night said they would not support the bill. But Mitch McConnell has a plan. Now he's going to ask the Senate to vote on a full repeal of Obamacare without anything to replace it. The repeal would come with a two-year delay to, quote-unquote, provide for a stable transition period. Health analysts think the chances of this bill passing is a pretty big question mark because it would leave millions of Americans without health care.
Why would you want to just get rid of it? Like, why not go, there are some good parts, let's keep some.
No, they're not getting it. They're giving up on getting rid of it, right?
No, but Mitch McConnell says
no, they want to get rid of it. They're just not going to replace it.
But keep in mind, if they do, and it won't pass, but if they do pass to say we're going to repeal it without replacing it, it stays in effect. for 2 more years.
Right.
So we're talking 2020 before anything would change. In the next 2 years, they're saying we'll surely come up with a better plan in the next 2 years. So it's not like anyone's going to lose their insurance tomorrow.
Right.
You still got it till 2020.
Right.
Or 2 years anyway.
Are you banking
and
on
they're hoping
coming
that in
up
2 years, for God's sake, we can come up with something.
Because they're certainly not going to talk to Democrats about it.
Well, that's what they said they would do this time.
No, so if this fails, then they'll talk to them.
We'll see.
That's what they say. The Lakers' Lonzo Ball is going to get an MRI today after being injured in the semifinal game of the Summer League tournament. He had to sit out the championship game. Although word is, if it had been a regular season game, they would have had him play. But Magic Johnson said in an interview, they're not sure how serious the injury is to his calf. They don't know if it's a tear or not. So they're going to
do
that.
Yeah, they just paid a lot of money for him. It's
oh,
like,
yes,
well,
they did.
Let's rest.
Yeah.
Well, they draft. I mean, they put a lot of hope into Lonzo. So, yeah, Summer League.
Don't hurt
it's
yourself.
It's supposed to be just, let's jog around to make some shots. But the Lakers did claim the Summer League crown.
Yeah, they did.
They won. They'd be the Portland Trailblazers. So whatever the hell that means. Ooh.
Hey, a win's a win. Dang it.
In other sports news, a Dallas Cowboy player named Ezekiel Elliott could be in some big trouble. He had a great rookie season.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, Eric. But his future could be in question. He was in a bar Sunday night in Dallas. And according to witnesses, a DJ who'd been drinking got into an argument with a woman who was in his group, and at some point Ezekiel went after the guy, broke his nose.
Oh.
The guy was on the ground. There's some video of it. They had to call an ambulance. Now, no complaint's been filed yet, but the NFL is going to look into this, and they're already investigating him for allegedly assaulting a woman in Ohio last year, and there was going to be a 1 or 2 game suspension around that. So
anger things.
Yeah.
What is it, those NFL guys? Just a couple days ago, there's a wide receiver from the Broncos that slapped a bouncer.
Receiver slapped a bouncer in
slapped
the face.
Slap. Come on. That's stupid
You're
stuff.
You're living the dream. Stop screwing it up, dummy.
Do something
and you
stupid.
Only have so many years anyway, right? It's a short-lived career. Mm-hmm. And two couples are trying to get their daughters back are accusing R. Kelly of running a sex cult. BuzzFeed interviewed the parents and some former members of R. Kelly's inner circle, and supposedly there are 6 women that he has living in rented properties in Chicago and Atlanta, and they say he controls everything. Who they contact, like their parents, or don't contact, what they wear, what they eat. He apparently has them engage in sexual encounters that he controls and records, and they say that he keeps them in line through physical, verbal, and emotional abuse.
Oh, bull.
The problem is, they're all of age. None of them are underage.
Well, see,
so
if you want to be there, then I don't have a problem
really
with this.
Like,
whatever. But if you're being held there and I can't call my mom.
That makes sense.
I mean,
but
I can't call my mom. That's where you're like, that work is culty.
Why would you want to call your mom to say you're part of R. Kelly's sex slaves?
Well, maybe I wouldn't tell her that, but I'm just checking in.
That's the last person I'm calling.
Might want to just check in and see how she's doing.
Was it R. Kelly?
You're in trouble.
Ah, boy, is she going to be pissed.
You're in trouble.
You're in. It's fine.
Okay, whatever. It's R. Kelly.
Was it R. Kelly years ago, and I mean like 15, 17, 20 years ago, there was accusations way back then of an underage
Yeah,
thing?
And there have been accusations since then, too.
So he's an easy target. Doesn't mean he's guilty now.
Was it underage or was it just the pee videos?
No, they were underage.
Underage pee videos.
Accusation
yeah. Thank God. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right now, McDonald's, get any size soft drink for only $1. Sorry.
The small
Sorry,
size.
McDonald's.
The
news
small
is news.
Young size.
I didn't plan this. And for only $2, get any small cafe drink, a small frappe, a shake or a smoothie for only $2 only at McDonald's. I'm loving it. Price and participation may vary. Limited time.
You're loving it. They are.
Offer.
Have the small innocent size, please.
That's news of the day.
1-800-955-5567 is the number. It's going to be winner's choice of prize. We come black. Come black.
No.
See.
Go to the doctor.
The wheels are really falling off.
What the hell is that? I gotta stop smoking. No. When we come. When we come back, we're going to play Get the Fake Out next.
Coming up on Frosty, Heidi, and Frank, sponsored by AccountTemps. Ed Sheeran has deleted his Twitter profile after being mocked. We'll have more details at 10 before the hour. Do you need accounting and finance professionals for long-term or recurring projects? If so, AccountTemps Salaried Professional Service may be the right solution. Visit AccountTemps.com. AccountTemps, a Robert Half company.
Do you know absolutely nothing about the stock market? Well, good. That means you're the perfect student for Online Trading Academy. They're a brick-and-mortar school. They're right here in Southern California. They started over 20 years ago, and they're so good at what they do. They've expanded to 40 campuses around the globe. Maybe you're thinking, why do I need to learn this stuff? Well, for starters,
You want to be chained to your paycheck? Wouldn't it be nice if you had a skill set to make money on your own and not totally rely on that 9-to-5 job, and you don't need to know anything about the stock market? Like I said, Online Trading Academy wants to teach you, and you can learn at your own pace. Start trading for just a few hours a week on your smartphone or laptop, and they have an amazing community of people who want to support you every step of the way. So do what I did. Call my friends at Online Trading Academy. They have a patented core strategy that can help you learn to follow what Wall Street is doing and how to profit along with them. And that's whether the market goes up or down. It's kind of like magic. And they're going to let you in on that secret. They're offering a free Wall Street Insider Kit so you can get started right away. Just call this number, 888-991-TRADE. That's 888-991-TRADE. Two online classes and instructional videos are going to throw that in. And a guide that will help you learn to build that second income. And two free tickets to an upcoming workshop. So bring a friend and learn how to make money. And all you have to do is call this number, 888-991-TRADE.
The KLOS Surf Report is brought to you by your Southern California Ford dealers. Ford, the best-selling brand in America.
Now, the KLOS Surf Report with Surf Junkie Jeff.
Good Tuesday morning, surf addicts. Well, it's looking like another day of mediocre energy. Those conditions are fairly clean out there with a minor mix of south swell and northwest energy. Most LNOC beaches are pulling knee to waist high plus waves with the best combo spot stomach high with the occasional plus set. 6 this morning, tide pushed up to a 3.3 high and then drops to a 1.8 low. 11 later this morning. If you're going to get wet, that spring seal will do the job with that water temp between 68 and 70 degrees. I'm Surf Young Jeff, combing the coast on the Rock of Southern California, 95.5 KLOS.
Stop by O'Reilly Auto Parts and pick up 5 quarts of O'Reilly Full Synthetic Motor Oil and a MicroGuard filter for $21.99. Extend the life of your vehicle and save money with 5 quarts of O'Reilly Full Synthetic Motor Oil and a MicroGuard filter for $21.99. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day. Limits apply. See store for details.
O'Reilly Auto Parts.
You're not like anyone else on campus. You are a denim-devoted gastronomy major nap machine, and you think you nailed your back-to-school shopping. Fresh denim, a microwave and a coffee maker, a plush new body pillow, and a stack of fresh sheets. But did you check eBay? If you did, you'd see that eBay has deals on the whole back-to-school checklist. And just like that, you realize that your Friday night fun could have had a lot more funding. Go back to school like nobody else. eBay, fill your cart with color.
The blues. Everyone gets them. But depression isn't just a feeling of sadness. It can affect the way you see the world. Your body may constantly feel fatigued, and your mind may dwell on thoughts of worthlessness and guilt. If you've had a case of the blues for too long and it's causing you to lose interest in the things you love, please listen carefully. Those feelings of hopelessness or pessimism, insomnia or difficulty concentrating may be symptoms of clinical depression. CNS is currently seeking participants for a depression clinical research study. You may be qualified if you're diagnosed with depression, currently take antidepressants, and are 18 years or older. Investigational medication and clinic visits are at no cost to qualifying participants, and compensation may be available for time and travel. To learn more, contact CNS today at 844-714-7474 or visit them on the web at cnstrial.com/depression. That's 844-714-7474. CNS, searching for a cure together. 844-714-7474.
Results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services. If you owe the IRS back taxes, payroll taxes, or have not filed your returns, the IRS will get you. They can take your property, take you to court, even put you in jail. With one call to WAL, you'll never need to talk to the IRS again. Our average client settles for about 10% of what is owed. We offer free face-to-face consultations in your local area. Call 800-727-0433. That's 800-727-0433.
Burger King presents Breakfast Stories. Here's Pete, Tony, and the 2 for $4 croissant sandwich deal.
The other day, Pete and I go to Burger King for my croissant sandwich. You know, they're just 2 for $4.
Oh, it's my favorite. I'm like, what?
Yeah, so I got 2 croissant sandwich, and I give one to this guy.
I'm like, who are you?
I'm the guy that just paid for your breakfast.
That's my favorite guy.
You guys, the croissant sandwich deal is 2 for $4. Now made with 100% butter for a soft and flaky croissant. Get 2 croissant sandwiches now for $4 only at Burger King. Price and participation vary.
A cure for hepatitis C. Breakthroughs in HIV treatment, multiple sclerosis, and diabetes. Millions of lives saved and improved by science. Yet still science is often not a straight line to success. So here's to the path to progress. Traveled by 140,000 researchers with America's biopharmaceutical companies. Here's to the long road, to the twists and turns that try men's and women's souls. Here's to frustration and fatigue and dead ends. Here's to permission to fail so that success can follow. And here's to brave patients, 125,000 here in California, enrolled in clinical trials to help find new breakthroughs, one of which might save their life, and perhaps one day, yours. Welcome to the future of medicine for all of us, where together we go boldly. A message from America's biopharmaceutical companies. Visit goboldly.com.
Hey, it's Peter Tilden, and I want to tell you about Flooring Pros. Their selection and prices are definitely going to floor you because they've got beautiful natural hardwoods, laminates, vinyl, and tile, and they can beat the price of the big national advertiser who you see advertised every day by as much as 50%. And they get it done right because they have an enormous selection and everything is in stock. That means you can get a free estimate one day and installation the very next day. So check out FlooringPro.com. They're on Google. They're on that beautiful website, Howls, and check out their Yelp reviews. They're fantastic. So for the largest selection and the finest hardwoods, environmentally friendly flooring, laminates, exceptionally trained experts, and the best price guaranteed, call the number one flooring company in Los Angeles, FlooringPro.com at 800-815-1565. That's 800-815-1565. Call them for a free estimate or go to FlooringPro.com.
Flooring Pro, their prices will floor you.
From the Morongo Casino Studios, it's Frosty, Heidi, and Frank on 95.5 KLOS and KLOS HD1.
Los Angeles.
Frosty, Heidi, and Frank Show, 1-800-95-5-5-5-6-7 is the number. I have several headlines here. All are true but one. It's time to play Get the Fake Out.
The following stories are true. Except for one. It's fake. It's up to you to get the fake out.
All right, here are your headlines. Ed Sheeran to follow Game of Thrones cameo with the Simpsons role as Lisa's love interest.
Oh God, it's the end of time.
Huh. O.J. Simpson's parole hearing will reportedly air live on ESPN.
Massive ratings if it does. That's all I can say.
Carrying swords now legal in Texas.
Swords?
Swords. Swords.
Oh, you.
A kid born with half a heart just completed his first children's triathlon.
I know a radio host with no heart at all doing a feature.
Green Day's Billy Joe Armstrong and Rancid's Tim Armstrong form supergroup called Armstrongs. Mm-hmm. Surgeons find 27 contact lenses in woman's eye.
What?
And finally, new iPhone app keeps your husband from cheating by forwarding his mom any incoming dirty texts. 1-800-955-5567 is the number. Get the fake out. All right. Wow. Everyone's still writing, except for Lisa. Lisa thinks she knows it. What's up, Lisa?
Well, my boyfriend wears contact lenses, and when he gets two in the same eye, you think he's going to die. Like, it's so awful. I can't imagine.
Yeah, how many did you say, Frank?
He said 27.
27?
That's insane.
Because at some point, you're like, okay, I've got my first one in. That's my prescription. Now I put the second one in. Oh, wow, I can't see it all.
Right.
Yeah. Because my prescription has now doubled it weird.
And then somewhere between 3 and 27, your eyelid doesn't close.
So you all three agree this has to be the contact lenses. Yeah, surgeon finds 27 contact lenses in woman's eye.
I'm torn between that one and not and swords illegal in Texas. You can just walk around Texas carrying a sword into a bank even if you want to. Come on.
Lisa, you going with the contacts?
I am.
I'm joining Lisa on that one. I just because I wear contacts as well. I can't physically understand.
What are you going with? Which one?
Well, I'll go. Since I'm torn and they picked that one, I'm going to go swords legal in Texas.
Okay. Yeah. Eric, if you could pick.
Ed Sheeran recently deleted his Twitter from all the backlash from the Game of Thrones appearance, so I don't think he'd put himself through that torture again on another TV show.
Okay, I'm picking that one. 1-800-955-5567 is the number. Let's go to Brent. Hello, Brent.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Pretty good. Get the fake out.
O.J. Simpson's parole hearing on ESPN.
O.J. Simpson's parole hearing will reportedly air live on ESPN. That is true. Yes, it just might air next Thursday. No, it actually will. next Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern time. What time is it?
10.
Ooh, right at the end. Well, it'll be the end of the show. Mm-hmm. Katie and Marcy's show. They should just broadcast that live on KLOS.
I read yesterday that some legal experts are saying he may actually get parole this time, based on whatever they base such.
His lawyer thinks so. This is parole in the state of Nevada is really based on how you behave in prison, and by all accounts, he's been a model prisoner. So, 70 years old, he was sentenced to a minimum of 9 years and a maximum of 33 years in prison for kidnapping and burglary in 2008, and going to appear in front of the parole board in Nevada at 1 p.m. Eastern time next Thursday on July 20th.
This Thursday.
This Thursday?
Yeah.
It's this Thursday, this week,
day after tomorrow? Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
Day after tomorrow. This is the big story. 100 million people watched him drive around in that white Bronco.
Well,
on the back seat, anyway.
Curious about the parole hearing.
Let's make bets. I say he goes free.
I'm with you. I think he does, too. Finally, I think he does.
I hope he does so that he can finally get back out there and try to find the killer of his wife. And, you know, what?
Yeah.
What? That's what he was doing before he went to...
Robert Shapiro is representing Rob Kardashian. Robert Shapiro, who was representing OJ.
Mm-hmm.
He's representing Rob Kardashian in his custody case
with Blac Chyna.
At least this time, the only thing his client double murdered is a couple Cinnabons.
Come on, Rob.
Too soon, Frank.
Too soon. For the Cinnabons?
Yes.
It's never too soon for Cinnabons.
Now I want a Cinnabon.
By the way,
that's true.
Simpson was supposed to pay the Goldman family, I think it was $35 million. You know how much he's paid? 1%. About $350,000. That's it. Now, unfortunately, all the money that Simpson had back then, he doesn't have anymore. He went bankrupt.
Nah.
Doesn't own his house anymore.
I feel like he's got it. He's got it.
Where does house go?
It was repossessed. He didn't make the payments. The bank took it back. Whoever bought it for like $4 million and knocked it down and put a new house up. So that's gone.
Yeah,
he didn't make money from he lost his endorsements. All that money's gone away. So he's got,
NFL pension.
But he doesn't have the $35 million anymore, so the Goldmans will never get the money.
Yeah.
Sadly.
Let's see. Let's go back to the phones. Let's find out what Freddie thinks. Hello, Freddie.
Hey, good morning.
You playing Get the Fake Out. Which one do you think's fake?
The 27 contact lenses.
We're going with Lisa and Frosty. Yeah, that is true.
Oh, there's no way, Frank. How is that?
Sorry, Freddie.
Really?
Yeah, an ophthalmologist in England made a shocking discovery while trying to operate on a patient last year. The woman had 27 contact lenses still in her eye. She's a 67-year-old patient. Said she was unaware the lenses were missing. She told surgeons she felt discomfort but thought it was due to dry eyes and her age. The woman went in for cataract surgery, and the operating team found a bluish mass of 17 contact lenses all stuck together. I have a picture of that. Following further examination, they found 10 more individual lenses in the woman's eye. So I'm thinking they're just 10 lenses not stuck together, but just roaming around in there.
Behind her,
the other side of the ball.
Look how thick that wad of lenses is.
She probably didn't even have cataracts. It's like, oh, no,
yeah,
it's
the cataract
fine now.
Surgery was postponed because there were no cataracts.
Oh.
No, I don't know. Well, I'm sure she's glad.
I mean, I've never worn contacts, but I feel like...
Even the soft ones, even the daily wear soft ones.
You wear contacts.
Yeah, and like Lisa said, if you put two on top of each other, you feel that. And that wad, you're showing that photo there, and our VIPs are watching online.
She's going to close her eyes. Don't her eyes are dry.
It's like half an inch thick.
That is insane.
Oh!
What the hell?
Just shows there's a bunch of stupid people out there. Yeah. No one told we got to take them out.
No, she's been wearing disposable contact lenses for 35 years, but had not been to the optometrist for her regular appointments. She had not reported any symptoms that could be linked to the missing lenses.
But not seeing.
So.
I mean, it's like,
she thought she was just getting old. Like, this is what happens. And I haven't been to the optometrist, so my prescription needs to be changed. But I haven't been in there to take the eye test, so I'm just going to keep wearing the ones that I got. And then she was getting old and forgot to take them out.
You know, for 27.
I knew a guy with Alzheimer's that forgot he got dressed. By noon, he had on 4 pairs of pants and sets of suspenders.
Yeah, I can't understand that. You would think feel it and see it, but I guess you can't.
How do you know you don't have? You're putting pants over pants.
I guess.
She was probably losing it a touch.
With Alzheimer's, you probably should make them wear glasses. Contacts, sorry, because they forget to take the old ones out.
That's right.
And they'll just lose their glasses.
Well, it's better.
Super glue them to their face.
Well, if they're wearing 27 pair of glasses.
My grandma's teeth went missing. She had her teeth, and then somebody else, I guess, wandering around, thought that was their teeth, but my grandma's teeth in, so we spent the whole day looking for grandma's smile. We're like, hey, smile, lady. No, it's not grandma. Hey, buddy, I'm your grandson. I'm not really his grandson, but I just wanted to smile, see if he had grandma's teeth in.
Oh, God.
Getting old sucks.
When we had grandma at the Alzheimer's ward the last few months of her life, she had a boyfriend, Anyway, he was like 97, she was 95. And he was talking about his garden. He said, oh, he would love, come watch me tend my garden.
Yeah.
And he's always talking about his garden, how the crops, oh, they've had good years so far, lots of rain, the crops are knee high.
And she whipped your grandma's skirt up, and you're like, no, no.
Frank.
That's what he called it, tending his garden.
You're making a beautiful story, something putrid. Stop it.
Yeah, it's a beautiful story.
She thought he meant I had it. Well, wait. She thought he meant he had a field out somewhere. And she goes, where is your garden? He goes, well, here, I'm going to show you. Come with me. It's down the hall. Down the hall. Okay, yeah, it's in my room. Okay, so he opens the door to the bathroom, and all the linen napkins he'd stolen from lunch were there on the floor. That was his garden.
Oh, so all colorful.
Yeah, all the napkins.
I wouldn't say that's a beautiful story. It's pretty sad.
Well, you're right.
But to him, he's happy. He's got a garden.
But he would look down and see cabbage and corn and squash and kumquats or whatever he's going
to. Probably a rose garden since they were all red napkins. You figure.
Yeah.
1-800-955-5567. The headlines that remain. Ed Sheeran to follow Game of Thrones cameo with The Simpsons role as Lisa's love interest. Carrying swords now legal in Texas. A kid born with half a heart just completed his first children's triathlon. And Green Day's Billy Joe Armstrong, Rancid's Tim Armstrong form supergroup called Armstrongs. And new iPhone app keeps your husband from cheating by forwarding his mom any incoming dirty text. All right, let's go to Richard. Hey, Richard.
Hey, Frosty, Heidi, and Frank. Good morning.
Get the fake out for your choice of prize.
I think it's the Ed Sheeran story, Game of Thrones one.
Are you a Game of Thrones fan?
No, I'm not, actually.
Oh, never mind then. That is true, unfortunately, for you. Yes, a lot of people were upset that Ed Sheeran did have that cameo in Game of Thrones. I don't know if they just don't like Ed Sheeran or they felt like it took you out of it.
Was he any good?
That's Ed Sheeran. Well, they had him sitting around a campfire singing.
Oh.
And then he didn't really have any lines. So when they did have the dialogue around the campfire, he was just guy sitting by campfire. But he was the one you heard singing the song. And then they all started to sing along. And then they had to acknowledge it so you get a close-up of him. Like, I never heard that song before. He's like, it's new. And then that was it.
That's weird.
That really didn't move the plot line forward.
It takes you out of watching Game of Thrones, and
it's
becomes
like Ed Sheeran there in armor.
He's got a really good agent, apparently.
Yeah.
A needless insertion.
Do you have the audio? If you're
down from Mr. Long Park, all the winds and the steps and the carving, he rode to a woman's side. For she was a secret treasure. She was his shame.
The drummer sucks.
And a chain and a keep are nothing compared to a woman's kiss. For hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm. For hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm.
It's a pretty song. I've never heard it before.
It's a new one.
That's his line. It's a new one.
That was it. Sort of pointless, wasn't it?
It's a new one.
I'd rather hear him go, I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. Walk all night and sleep all day. No.
Oh. So that is true. Let's see. Let's go to John. Hello, John.
Hello.
Get the fake out.
Swords legal in Texas, being able to carry them.
I'm with you.
No, I don't think
Heidi chose as well. That is true. Swords now legal to carry in Texas. Would you be for this? If you don't want people to carry guns, how about we all carry? Well, it says, the law actually says there's a bill signed by the governor of Texas. It goes into effect actually on September 1st. But yeah, Governor Greg Abbott signed the bill into law last month. This says anything a blade longer than 5.5 inches.
That's not a sword.
Well. If it's longer than 5.5 inches, you could technically carry a sword,
machete.
Spear, dagger, saber, Bowie knife, machete, all perfectly fine to tote around. So if everybody had, you know, like medieval times, we all wear these giant swords around. You think people, the society would be different?
I think they'd be better behaved, just like you. I think it's fine. I do.
You don't want me to pull this thing out, Heidi.
I don't want to see it here, but Texas, fine. Let's see how it works.
You can't.
It's
only 5 inches.
Wait.
Wait a second. What? Yeah, under the existing law, knives with blades longer than 5.5 inches could be purchased, but not carried. You could own it, but you just can't carry it around, which what's the point?
It's just a bitch to carry a sword around, though, I would imagine.
There's some places the new law won't apply, including schools. Can't take a sword to school.
Well, yeah, there's common sense here as well.
Prisons, hospitals, amusement parks, or places of worship.
What about bars?
Long blades are still banned in sporting events, and you can't bring your sword into a bar either. So really, that's the public for me.
Out on the range, out in your ranch, you might see a rattlesnake, need to chop it up or something.
But if I'm on my own ranch, I can carry whatever I want. I can carry a gun out there.
That's true.
It's my property.
Mm. As long as you keep them out of bars, I'm cool with it. Because you don't want to mix alcohol and swords.
Yeah, bars and churches.
And Texans.
But why can't you take your blade to church?
I don't know. You'd think that would...
You figure it'd be one of the places. Or a hospital. That way, I'll just put that pillow over your head and struggle. I can just hack.
Bye, Grandma.
So why?
We're going to unplug her?
Yeah.
No, let's use our swords,
let's
finally.
Let's do it the fun way.
Yeah,
we're allowed to. They just
all together.
It.
Hey, LC's here. Okay, let's go to, let's see, we got Jeff, who thinks it's the Armstrong Band, the supergroup. Megan thinks it's the new iPhone app that prevents your husband from cheating by sending all incoming dirty texts to his mom. And Gregory thinks it's the half-heart kid who completed his first children's triathlon. One of you gets your choice of prize, the others get nothing. The fake headline is... New iPhone app keeps your husband from cheating by forwarding his mom any incoming dirty text. So, Megan, you won.
All right. Thank you so much.
All right. Do you want to go to Comic-Con at the San Diego Convention Center? Starts tomorrow through Sunday for one day. Or do you want to go to Mystery Science Theater 3000 or the Pacific Wine and Food Classic?
You know what I really want to do? I would really like to go to the Orange County Fair. Could you send me there?
Orange County Fair. Let me see. Yes, I can.
Yeah. All right. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it, guys.
A four-pack of tickets, Farm Fresh Fun, now through August 13th. So you're going,
awesome.
Megan.
Thank you so much.
Stay on hold, sweetheart. And yes, that one's true. That one's fake. The other two are true, meaning the kid born with half a heart did just complete his first children's triathlon. He has a rare condition called hypoplastic left heart syndrome, where one side of your heart doesn't develop in the womb. So without surgery, it's fatal, and the doctors actually suggested terminating the pregnancy. But Rob and Lauren, the parents, decided not to do that.
Well,
They're letting...
Risky,
they're letting.
But looking back, it was the right decision because there were a little quasi-miracle happened here, and the kid's great. It's fine.
What would you have done?
I don't know. That's got to be hellish dilemma. I don't know.
You got to make a decision right now.
No.
Tomorrow's too late.
I'm sleeping on it.
Can't sleep on it. Tomorrow's too late.
I would talk to all medical professionals I could.
You have. Hypoplastic left heart syndrome.
I don't know.
Usually fatal. Terminate it now.
Honey, you decide. I'll be at the pub. Let me know what you decide. Bye. Love you.
Oh, you're letting her decide.
All the tough decisions. You bail. Well, all right. What do you do, Heidi? Keep it or terminate?
Boy. Probably keep it at this point.
You would?
Yeah. And because if they're giving me hope and they're saying, listen, it can be fixed, but it's risky and it's, I mean, but they're saying, he's alive, so they're saying he can be fixed.
Is it going to suffer its whole life? I mean, most of these.
I'd have to go, is it going to
be? You don't know. I'm saying they had no idea. This is in the womb and doesn't develop that other right side of its heart. So usually fatal. He's going to have heart surgeries when he's young. So, what do you want to do here? We can terminate it now. You can try again.
I don't know.
For a healthy baby.
I honestly don't know.
I've had this conversation about healthy babies.
Jesus.
And I'm like, hey, yeah. No.
Eric had heart surgery. He was a little problem baby, and he turned out fine. Look.
Did your parents have the choice, Eric? I know it's your birthday, so it's kind of weird to talk about this.
Yeah, thanks.
But did your parents have the choice to terminate you or not?
Yeah, they did, actually.
They did?
Yeah, I mean, they knew I had heart problems very early on. My heart doesn't sound like your heart. Your heart goes ba-boom, ba-boom, ba-boom. That's what your heart sounds like. Mine goes boom, boom, boom.
Still, to this day,
still,
it goes boom.
Always. Forever. Forever and ever.
So when a doctor's listening to your heart, like, for a checkup and who doesn't know your situation, does he look at you like,
We got to get you in.
Do you know?
And I don't tell them. It's always so fun to watch their faces.
So if I feel your pulse, is the second thing weird? Is there a splat instead of a spurt?
My pulse feels normal.
But you sound weird.
Just
you sound like a goose-stepping Nazi with diarrhea.
So they could detect that very early on. So, yeah, my parents were given a choice, and they decided to keep me.
Were they advised that the odds are you're not going to make it and you probably should consider?
No, because they knew what I had, and they knew it would be a lot of surgery, but then I would come out on the other
side. Did they say it was usually fatal?
It's not usually fatal.
All right, then you, okay. In that case, you're like, oh, okay, he's going to have to go through some surgeries, but that's pretty easy surgeries.
But if the surgery didn't go well, because I was 2 when I had my first surgery.
Well, this kid was, let's see. This kid named Jack, he had his first heart surgery 4 days after he was born.
Oh, my God. That is torture.
Well, they told my parents, he's going to need surgeries, but he's got to get big enough. Because back in the 80s, the equipment wasn't big enough.
The microsurgery.
I mean, it wasn't small enough for those four-day-old surgeries. So they had to wait until my heart was actually big enough. So they said, man, the next 2 years are going to be a waiting game. If he sticks it out, then he'll be fine.
Can you imagine that little baby four-day-old chest cracker looks like an eyelash curler?
Oh. Just as painful.
I'll say, yeah, 4 days after he was born, had his first surgery. And another one at 4.5 months. And then a third open heart surgery when he was 2.5. So he had 3 by the time you had your 1.
Wow, this is before the days of Obamacare. Oh, sorry to bring that up.
This is, what a kid.
Now he's 6. And should be done with surgeries for a while. He might need a heart transplant when he's older. Thanks, Mom and Dad.
Or he might not.
But he basically has the normal life of a normal 6-year-old, and his doctors want him to be as active as possible. Now, he does get winded faster than other kids, but loves sports, so he plays ice hockey and just completed his first children's triathlon last month. It involves swimming the length of a pool, riding his bike around the park, and running the length of about 1.5 football field, so 150 yards.
See, I would tell my kid to take it easy and not be a triathlete, because if you push it...
No, but it's a muscle. You need to make it stronger.
I know, but in moderation. He's out there being a triathlete. He wants to be the next Caitlyn Jenner.
Muscle?
It would only make him feel guilty, this kid with half a heart. His kid, and he's out there exercising and loves sports. And Frosty's like, I have a whole heart, say, I've wasted it.
I'd say only run half as far as the other kids, only swim half as far, because you're half. You know what I'm saying? Take it easy.
Frosty's heart's going to be delicious when he dies. He's been marinating in butter all these years.
Oh,
dang.
Pictured on a spit roast with all the fat coming out.
That's why I'm going to eat you first, because you're probably delicious.
Oh, I know.
Please do.
Doubt.
I'd hate to go to waste.
Look how much bacon you have on you right now.
You would be good breakfast.
I'd be the most expensive Omaha steak in the catalog. All that marbling. All that delicious marbling going on in there. Years of juices all built up.
Yeah. Or would it be good? Because, I mean, he's not really grass-fed as far as vegetables go. He's not really a green-eating guy.
Yeah, that's true, too.
I don't know.
Well, the fat ones are the moist. The grass-fed can be, chewy.
But you could be fatty and gristly.
If we fed a cow Doritos with cheese on for its entire life, then we can know what you taste like.
The most delicious cow ever.
Why don't you buy a cow and feed it nothing but Doritos and cheese and see what the steaks would be like? Maybe it's awesome. Doritos and Jameson.
Stillwell steaks.
Stillwell steaks. Yeah, start your own business.
I'll bet I make my own gravy too, just like Gravy Train. What do you think?
So the Green Day, Billy Joe Armstrong and Rancid's Tim Armstrong formed a supergroup called Armstrongs. That is actually true. And I have a clip, if my computer wouldn't go to sleep every time I stop using it. Let's see.
It's Energy Star.
Oh, I know. Got to pay the bill around here.
We saved half a penny of energy by letting it shut off in the middle of the show.
Maybe I'll submit the DWP.
Get a rebate.
Be an advertiser. And get my bonus. All right, here is a little taste of the Armstrongs.
This is a beer commercial if I ever heard it. I want a drink.
I like this. That's great. I can hear this in Game of Thrones.
You like it?
Love it.
It makes you want to drink, doesn't it? It's a beer commercial.
Totally.
I saw Rancid about 2 years ago at Coachella, and they killed. Destroyed it. It's awesome.
This is a song you can buy right now? Out there?
I think you can. Let's see. Where can we get it?
Did they do an entire album or just the one song? You know? I like this.
I love it.
If this comes on Friday afternoon at the pub,
come on.
Crank it up.
Doesn't say where you can get it. Yeah, look, it's if There Was Ever a Time is the name of the song by the Armstrongs. Billy Joe Armstrong, Tim Armstrong, together. Right. Now the time is right for traffic. What's going on, Lisa?
Traffic report is brought to you by your Southern California Chevy dealers. Stalled truck reported on the 405 southbound around Sherman Way in the left lane. Traffic goes busy anyway southbound as you come away from about Roscoe Boulevard. Sigler continues eastbound 60 at Grand with the right two lanes closed down as crews work to retrieve a truck that went over the side. Eastbound 60 backed up from Brea Canyon. There was also a Sigler on the 60 westbound around Mountain in Chino. That's been canceled. All lanes are open. But a new problem for the 60 westbound. This is a wreck just beyond Azusa, an injury accident in the middle lane of traffic. And on the South 57, lots of delays now from Sunset Crossing all the way down to the 5 freeway. This summer, visit your Southern California Chevy dealer to experience all the excitement Chevy has to offer. Go for thrilling rides and deals as impressive as the Chevrolet award-winning lineup at the Chevy Summer Drive happening now. Learn more at SoCalChevy.com. That's traffic on 95.5 KLOS.
Are you paying too much for auto insurance? Visit AAA.com/insurance for a free quote and find out how much you could save. Find competitive rates on auto insurance through the Auto Club. Visit AAA.com/insurance today.
All right, are you hiring? If so, do you know where to post your job to find the best candidates? We got the hookup for you. ZipRecruiter. With ZipRecruiter, you can post your job to 100-plus job sites with just one click. I'm going to hire a new co-host. Aw. Then their powerful technology efficiently matches the right people to your job. They do it better than anybody else, and that's why ZipRecruiter is different, because unlike other job sites, ZipRecruiter doesn't simply depend on candidates finding you. It finds them for you. In fact, over 80% of jobs posted on ZipRecruiter get a qualified candidate in just 24 hours. And like I said, it's quick. No juggling emails or calls to your office.
If there ever was a time to use ZipRecruiter, it's now.
Yeah!
Use ZipRecruiter. To ZipRecruit now. To hire your brothers and your sisters. It's not nepotism if it's ZipRecruiter. All right, yeah, ZipRecruiter.com/FHF. One more time to try it for free. Go to ZipRecruiter.com/FHF.
Do it. Woo!
Once upon an OC time, when crops thrived in the sun, a farmer's book showed us the way to harvest farm fresh fun. It started on a crazy ride on roller coaster vines. Next thing you knew, it looped you through spun cotton candy skies. The chickens made their way up high, tied to flying balloons. Good eats were hatching left and right. Live music played in tune. The OC Fair's now back in town, and with it, farm fresh fun. There's rides, there's food, beer tasting too. It's all under the sun. Round up your friends and look ahead. Good times you'll come to spend. The OC Fair won't be here long. It's fresh fun till the end.
Celebrate farm fresh fun at the OC Fair July 14th through August 13th. Find out more at ocfair.com.
And now for one of my three all-time favorites.
You're locked on Frosty, Heidi, and Frank.
On the Rock of Southern California, 95.5 KLOS.
If there's ever a time to talk about working.
I know, it's stuck in your head, isn't it?
It's now, baby. Mm-hmm. Frosty, Heidi, and Frank, as you get to work today, look around and see if you see anybody with tattoos on their face or neck. There's some people that won't hire them.
Chances are you're not at the bank.
Yeah, you know, it's at a tattoo parlor or a bar. I mean, certain places, auto mechanics, yeah. Oil
musicians,
change. I don't care.
Yeah.
But there's some places you got to realize if you put tattoos on your face and your neck, there are some businesses who may not hire you.
My bank
that.
Teller had tattoos on her face.
Was it on her neck coming up her chin like that?
It was on her arm, but like she had a sleeve, and I could see it coming out of her like dress shirt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Did it bug you in a weird sort of way? Well, not you, because you got tats. But if you were a 75-year-old lady depositing your Social Security check?
I think that she's like part of a heist,
yeah.
filling in for the real teller who's under the desk, duct taped.
Borrowed her shirt just to cover her tats.
Well, I'm going to show you a photo here in just a second of a teenager who says he's having trouble finding work. No one will hire him because of the tattoo he has on his face. Now, for whatever reason, he put the devastate, that's D-E-V-A-S-T, and the number 8, devastate, all the way from, reach over and touch your left ear, okay, touch
okay,
your left
so
ear.
For like ear.
Now, put your hand on your face and drag your hand all the way across your mouth, your chin.
Oh, it's on his
where
face?
A beard would be.
Right, exactly.
It looks and like a tattooed beard.
What he looks like for the rest of his life.
What's the word say?
Devastate.
If he just grew a beard out, he'd be fine.
Yeah, grow
you know
a beard.
I mean? Just grow a beard.
Exactly.
You're good. You just got to do that your whole
those
life.
Those guys with scalp tattoos, they wear their hair out. You can't see it.
They should grow a beard. But he's complaining now on social media that no one will hire him and it's not there. Oh. Well, dude, look what you did to your face.
Just say you've passed out at a frat house.
Say it's Sharpie marker. Hire me. It'll fade.
It's going to wear off.
But then it doesn't wear off and yeah. I hired you and you said it'd be worn off.
And then you can't fire me because it's discrimination.
So why do you suppose he did this? I have the reason. See if you can guess why.
Young and dumb.
Exactly it. He was a teenager.
Looks homemade. Like, that doesn't even look like tattoo.
It's awful.
Tattoo.
He had it. It was done when he was drunk as a teenager in the drunk tank in a jail cell.
Oh, God.
And his jail partner.
Then he was passed out.
No, he was drunk, but he was, conscious.
But not making good decisions.
But while in jail, he decided
dude,
to go
do
ahead,
it. Dude,
get a yeah, tattoo
cool.
in my face. Now, he was in jail because he and a friend, this is when he was a teenager now, he was 17 years old at the time. He and a friend pulled a knife on a tourist. He says the reason he committed the crime, trying to rob the tourist, is because he needed to get money to help house himself and his pregnant girlfriend.
Oh, swell.
After they were kicked out of his parents'
great,
house.
Great, great. Right.
And now he can't find a job because he looks like this.
Yeah, but he also is a felon, so it's also going to be harder to find a job when you go, hey, right. Have you ever been convicted of a felony? And you're like, do I tell the truth?
So if you're her, you think she's proud of her man. Oh, I just love him. I'm so proud. He's a catch.
Oh, I want him to be. Look at that guy. I want him to be the father of my children.
Well, he also has an eyebrow tattoo. What's that thing say above his eyebrow?
I don't know what to is can't read. He's got more
and
on his
a
body
neck
too.
Tattoo.
Yeah, it's just stupid.
Was the beard his first tattoo? Because that would be ridiculous. That's the story behind it. Yeah. My first tattoo is on my face.
I always wonder if some of you regret the ones you get later. Look, arm ones are cool. That's fine. Leg, but on your face and neck, don't you regret? At the time, maybe you're drunk.
I'll
or
probably
stupid.
Get neck tattoos at some point.
Frank, don't.
You can't even see my neck right now.
Yeah, but you'll eventually shave, and then we'll see it.
I don't think he's going to shave anymore. I think this is it.
You think
no!
For the rest of my life?
I think this is, he's found his thing.
Are you the permanent beard scraggly guy now?
I don't know. It's thick.
Isn't it hot and
no,
sweaty?
No, I don't even notice it. It's crazy.
It's
I've never
110
had a
degrees.
Like
you don't feel extra because you have no...
Actually, it's kind of cooling. It's like, long-haired dogs. It's like it keeps cold air
his
close
undercoat.
To my face.
Yeah.
It's my undercoat.
Okay. Yeah.
I haven't seen him sweat.
So it's nice. Kind of nice.
Right. But you have the option of shaving it off and it going away.
Right.
Tattoos are, well, I know you can have it removed, but that's expensive
and painful.
That's this is the rest of your life.
Mm-hmm.
See, I would think really, really long and hard about any tattoo I would get, and I have none.
You're on radio. I mean, big deal, you get a neck tattoo.
I don't want a neck tattoo. I don't want a tattoo
but
out
you
anywhere.
Could do this and have neck. You could have that guy's face. He could do radio.
Yeah, right.
Well, you're right. Radio.
But, so
he could go to KABC. No one would see him and no one would hear him.
It really is devastating. But Frosty, over the years, you've really been into things, so there was no chance of you ever getting like an Eagles tattoo.
No, see, that's
their
the thing.
Logo on your arm or
you just
Elton
on
John.
Or... Yeah, no matter how cool something is, now in 1977, Eagles tattoo would be cool.
Get a tattoo of Elton John's feather boa around your neck.
Hot pink.
In 1979, that might have been cool. Now it's not so cool.
Yeah.
I mean, some of you might be walking around with Huey Lewis in the news
even
on your
though
arm.
You still love the Eagles and you still love Elton John, so the tattoos wouldn't be like, God, what? How, when was I in this group?
They're yeah, but little, you never know what's going to... I mean, ABBA used to be cool once. What if I had an ABBA tattoo?
No, no, ABBA was ever cool.
Yeah, they were...
No, it's like saying Katy Perry's cool.
Dancing Queen. There was a time, man. Man, love ABBA.
I mean, we're going to go back and forth with ABBA songs versus Katy Perry.
Until you, I think, yeah, he'll run out first.
All right, let's battle it out. You say ABBA songs, I'll say Katy Perry songs.
Okay. Dancing Queen.
Firework.
Can you hear the drums, Fernando?
I kissed a girl and I liked it.
Waterloo. I couldn't beat you if I wanted to. Waterloo. What do you do?
I don't know.
I win.
Yeah, you won. You won that one.
Roar.
You're getting help over there.
Well, yeah. No, I don't think I really wanted to win that. If I
got
to take a loss on a game on this show, I'll lose that one every day.
You lose the ABBA challenge.
The ABBA Katy Perry challenge.
So,
face off.
Abba Perry face off, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So my point is the tattoo, especially something that's culturally hip today, it's not going to be cool down the road. Again, do you have a Hootie and the Blowfish tattoo somewhere?
You wouldn't get like your
you say your hairstyle's the same way. I mean, if you have a hairstyle that you had in the 80s, if you had a mullet and you're trying to go out and get a job today, are people going to really hire all the business in the front, party in the back? Probably not.
Probably
you can
not.
Get a haircut, but you love it. You dig it.
I'm not cutting my hair. Fashionably. No corporation. I can take it as it is.
You can't tell me to cut my hair. It's got to be against some law. Yeah. I'm American, Christ
sake. It's my religious freedom to have a mullet.
That's why I'm not going to hire you, see? Because once you're on the payroll, I can never get rid of you. See?
Yeah, if I'm the hiring guy. That's why no one here can get fired.
That's right. Once you're in, you're in.
Once you're in, they can't fire you?
No. Because you get sued or something.
Right. You got to have a lot of reasons to fire.
I'd say the smart thing to do if you're a business owner, as large or small, is don't hire the problem person. Don't hire him to begin with.
Well, yeah.
There's an update on your story, Frosty. The teenage father with devastate tattoo was now has job offers.
Oh, good.
He's still waiting for the right one because a laser company that takes off tattoos gave him free laser surgery.
So it's gone then?
They took it off his face, and now he's got all these job offers coming in. So.
Well, that's a happy ending. Do they know about his criminal past?
Right. Yeah, there is that.
I mean, he's tattoo free, but he's still a robber right. impregnator.
No, he did his time, right?
Yeah, but you still have to answer that on an application if you've been convicted of a crime.
Well, you shouldn't have to. I think if you paid your debt to society, then you don't have to tell him that you committed a crime.
Did I mention he escaped from jail as well?
Oh.
So we got aggravated robbery conviction, escape from jail, assault with a weapon, impregnated a girl, tattoo on the face.
And neck, and
eyebrow.
Yeah,
I want you working for my company and hanging out with my employees.
You don't want anybody who's pregnated girls in your company.
No.
Ew, icky vagina.
Get out of the treehouse.
No girls allowed.
No impregnated girls allowed.
Well, you all feel that way.
Icky vagina. Okay, I was just kidding. I don't want to hear the whole dance mix. We already did Abba Perry. We can't handle that.
That was very similar to Dancing Queen. Very similar.
How about should you get time off work after a breakup? Oh, your feelings hurt. Did someone break your heart? Will you just take some time off here? Get some days.
You should probably go to work. It would help you get over
it. Yeah, an ad agency called Idea Ex Machina, it's in the Philippines, just started offering breakup leave, which is paid time off after you get dumped. Paid time off. Maybe take a couple of days. We ain't paying you. If you got to get your head back together so you can, go cry it out and get back to work. I'm not paying you to go cry it out.
Well, yeah, I think I'm with you on that, Frank. If you need time to, because you're not going to be a very productive employee
it's
if
like
you're all screwed up.
Leave, right?
But why should I have to pay? Because you're the one with the problem. You screwed up.
The CEO says that they decided to start the policy because they need their staff to have maximum creativity because it's an ad agency and they're just not. It's possible after a breakup. You can't.
This is an ad agency.
You're thinking about one thing all the time.
Not a sad agency. Get out of here for a couple days. Damn it. Go on, Johnson. We'll see you in a few days.
That's my horrible Filipino accent, by the way.
However, no, it was dead on, actually. I've been to the Philippines. They all talk like that. They start smoking at a very young age. They've also added new policies where they'll give their staff $30 towards dates up to 6 times a year, and they'll kick it. They'll kick in $3,000 towards employee weddings. They want people to be out
happy.
There. Yeah.
Okay.
Be happy and in love and dating.
I guess that's fine if you're a better employee when you're happy and dating, fine.
If this company gave us $30 towards dates, each date, $30, would you be more likely to go out on dates, Frosty, to get that $30 just to go out and get the free meal?
It'd have to be more than that because $30 in the Philippines goes further than $30 in Los Angeles.
That's not the question.
It has to be
the economy of the Philippines. No.
Yes.
Don't evade the question $30
about
going out with women.
$30 in the Philippines is a nice date.
All right. What's they give you $1,000 for a date, which
now
basically ruins
we're talking.
It. No.
I still wouldn't, but now we're talking.
You still wouldn't go out on a date. Just take the free money.
It's discrimination against the people who choose not to date. You're discriminating.
Why would you choose not to date?
I don't want to date this week.
Happily single.
I'll take the money.
This week, it's 6 different dates throughout the year.
But you know,
so $180 towards just movies.
Fine.
They'll pay for your movie with a woman friend.
Define date, if that's what that is. That's fine. Eric, you want to go see Dunkirk this weekend? We're going on a date. Fine. $1,000. I'll split it with you. $500 each.
Single and looking, and then there's happily single. But Frosty's the happily single. He's not, you meet somebody like, you single? Yeah, single and looking? Yeah, yeah.
But then they'd never hire him then because they don't think single people could be happy, which they're the happiest people of all.
But,
but no, you are. I'm saying you are the happiest people of all.
I know I'm happy, damn it!
Don't fight me, you're happy.
I'm on your side. But the problem with giving big money to go on a date to find happiness, now there's, it's like, okay, I haven't found happiness yet. I haven't found the woman to settle down with. We've been giving you all this money, dude. Come on. Now there's an expectation that I'll find the happiness.
No, I think their motivation is not really your happiness. The motivation is to get you nailed down so you have to have a family to take care of and you can't quit your job.
Oh, right.
It's like pay for six dates and $3,000 towards your wedding. Now you're not just living for you. That you're going to be home early. You're going to, you know, you got to come to work because you got to provide for your family. So, really, I'm making you married to the company, but I marry you off to somebody else.
Makes sense. It's a good strategy.
You got a family to take care of.
When you're single, you can pick up and move whenever you want, and leave the company, and go to another single ad agency.
That is actually a very good strategy. Mm-hmm. Once you're locked in with ball and chain, so to speak, obligations.
Yeah. The Philippines have figured it out.
Well, some of it.
Right. Not all. Yeah.
And you can go on a date for $30.
That's a lot of baloo.
But would you take the time off after a breakup because you're upset?
No.
Well, how about this? Here in the United States, in Ann Arbor, Michigan, a lady is being criticized for taking time off. And she's bragging about this online, which is why people know about this. She takes time off regularly for sick days for her mental health.
Hmm.
She doesn't have the flu. She's not having kidney stone removed. Her, quote, health is fine physically. But mentally, I need to recharge. I'm upset. I'm burned out. My mental health needs a sick day. And she's taking her six sick days a year, claiming it's mental health sick days.
Well, I guess it's the same as what we get personal days here.
But why not just say, not really feeling like coming in? That's right. A sick day. Why do you have to go with the mental health sick
day? Why do you
have
to say, like, oh, I don't have the flu? Because maybe
just go with the, I ate something that made me sick.
Yeah, I feel good.
Oh, you have the poopies.
No one's going to
argue. I understand. No one's going to... You know, I'm mentally unstable and need to take a day. I'd rather tell you I have diarrhea.
Right.
So she's being honest, but maybe she shouldn't be honest.
Yeah.
Just say it's a sick day. Well. That's what a personal day is.
Yeah. He just told me yesterday he takes all of the sick days because we get sick days, you know, around here, I guess. I didn't know that until yesterday because I never take a sick day.
Mm-hmm.
But Eric takes all his for his Christmas vacation.
Eric!
In a row because he never takes sick days either.
No, I don't.
All right.
That's not what I do.
But if you
I never do that. I was legitimately sick the last
because
4 years.
Because you can't roll over sick days. You can roll over vacation days if you don't use them, but you can't roll over sick days. So you got to use those as your vacation days.
Ha
ha.
Eric would never do that.
System.
But if Eric did do that, though he never would, you would claim you would lie saying you were ill.
Why would you come in today on December 23rd because I'm sick.
I'm mentally unstable.
Here's the thing. If you're the boss, you're the company. If Eric has got the flu, hell, everyone gets the flu. Everyone gets cold. Rest up. We'll see you when you're better, right?
Ulterior motive here. It's a better way to keep your job. If you have already claimed and told the company you have mental issues, they can't get rid of you for that because then it's even worse than getting rid of you for having diarrhea.
That's right.
I know. But weirdly, I don't want you. Oh, this is going to sound terrible. I shouldn't even say it. But if you confess to me you're so mentally fragile.
Mm-hmm.
You can never be fired.
I know, but you're telling me, you're coming out and saying 6 days a year, this woman says, I suffer from chronic anxiety, depression, I still have PTSD from something or other, I can't focus, I'm fragile. So you're telling me you're enough. I'm not sure you should be working for it.
So you can't fire them.
No.
The unstable are locked in.
Totally locked in.
So this woman is guaranteed work for life.
Yep. Because there's no way you can get rid of
her. Even if she goes off her medication, whatever, you have to get her help first. And then she can keep doing that. Because if you ever fire her, she can sue you.
I know, but what a crappy employee.
For not providing a water bubbler close enough to her desk so she could take her pill in time. The system is screwed.
It is. Would you entrust some big, huge, important client or sales project that's going to be full of stress and anxiety to this woman?
She's great, but
I think that's the problem. I think instead of like offering the tax incentives to the small businessman or whatever it might be to go, we're going to create jobs. No, we need to create the ability to fire people again.
Yes.
Without the ability to sue the company and claim all this other stuff. It's like, no, if you're incompetent and you're not doing your job, you can get fired. So do your job. Everyone needs to be doing their best. Because, I talk to guys all the time. The guy's in a position to be hiring people who could. I told him about ZipRecruiter. I'm like, maybe try this, dude. Because he's I'll see 20 people come in. Maybe one out of 20 has the qualifications and, the enough oomph for me to take a risk on them. And even then, it's a risk because once I get them in the door, they could start just being lazy bastard and I can't fire them. I have to do something else. And he's miserable. He's miserable at his job because he hires all these guys And women, doesn't matter. It's like, and then they just, once they get in the door, they know they're protected. And so they don't have to do their job.
They just coast. Yeah, they just, you know, phone it in.
They just coast.
And that's a shame.
So if I was president, I'd be like, no, I'm creating the ability to fire people
again.
Because
back when we were kids or teenagers and we were working, if you didn't show up and they were like, hey, listen, you got to be here at 7, okay? 7:15, 7:20, that's not doing it. This is your warning. And you show up late again, you're done. Now it's like, well, did you write it down? Is there a paper trail? No, I just told him in person. Well, we kind of need you to, you know, document each time. And you're like, oh, Jesus.
The jobs that I would create for this country is more axemen. Guys who come in for corporations and just fire people. Just chopping off heads.
Don't need him.
Yes. And I know there's awful things going back, looking back in time. We've fixed some still need to be fixed. But in the old days, so to speak, when you could fire poor employees without being sued, wouldn't the country's economy, wouldn't the country in better shape? If someone waddles in and says, oh, I suffer like this woman. I suffer from insomnia. I don't get a good night's sleep most nights. I have suicidal thoughts. I have chronic anxiety, depression most of the time.
Then, listen,
the only thing you're basing the job on then is the person who is the hardest worker and the most qualified. Doesn't matter background, color, gender. It doesn't. That is all gone because the employee then has the opportunity to go, I want the best employees. It doesn't matter. I don't care who you are, what you are, if you bust your ass for me in this company, then you will go up in the company, and I want you on my team. That's what it is.
It's Darwinism.
You got to put good people around you. Yeah, and if not good people, you're going to fall off to the wayside. You're only going to go so far up this ladder. And it's not because anybody's privileged or anybody's underprivileged. It's about how you do the job and work your ass off. And that's how you get to the top.
That's the way it used to be and should be. But all of you, look around. If you're at work already
Kramer
at 7:40.
2020.
And look around the office. Don't point fingers. Look around. There's people there right now, you know, that should not be there.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not up on the system.
And they shouldn't there because they're crappy workers. They don't work nearly as hard as most everyone else. But they're there because maybe the company can't.
Like here, Maria says, legally, you do not have to say what is wrong with you when you take a sick day. Because if they ask you, then you could sue them.
Right, exactly.
And now, a caller who hung up says that you can't even ask anymore an application if anyone's committed a felony. Like, that's...
Wow.
Yeah, here in the state of California, they think they were debating that a couple years ago, Hutton, and I am so opposed to that.
No, Frosty, then you're going against what I just said.
No.
If that guy with the devastate tattoo beard on his face and a felony under his belt turned his life around, now he's the hardest worker and the best worker I got. I don't care. It's about the business. It's not about your dumbass tattoo when you were young and stupid. It's not the fact that you got that chick pregnant or whatever car you stole. It's about what you're doing right now in this moment, and it's for the company.
I'm hiring you, dude.
Maybe not at the front desk, but
in the getting to know you phase, when I sit down and I'm looking, we need an employee.
Then you're discrimination.
Wait a minute, we need to hire some employees. And so you're all coming in and you're all competing with people and you're giving me resumes and we're supposed to be an even playing field.
Yeah.
How is it I can ask you about everything else about your past, your education level, where you live, but I can't ask you if you ever did time in prison? Really? So let's say you get the job over the guy who has the exact same qualities as you, but he didn't spend 20 years in prison for armed robbery and rape and assault and murder and pillaging and burning a town down. I can't even ask you about that.
I understand
that's
the
not
effort.
Fair to the other guys.
But I understand it's not fair to that guy either. Like I said, if he did turn his life around, I mean, those people who are born again and find Jesus. Well, okay, he's a completely different guy, supposedly.
But you're acting like the time in prison never happened. It did happen.
You're acting like that's all that ever happened.
But it's
you
part
gave him
of
a life,
your,
you gave him a life sentence.
It's part of your life story.
No, you gave him a life sentence.
No, he could never move on.
He's from
done
that.
The time, and he did. Okay, fine. He's excused because he did the time. But the fact is, you're acting like that big, huge chunk of your life didn't.
Why
happen.
Why does it matter then?
But it did happen. It is part
but
of
why
who
does it
you,
matter now?
It's part of your life story, just like everything else.
You're not answering my question. Why does it matter right now?
Because your resume is who are you?
It's not my history. It's my
it
future.
It is
with
your
you.
Life.
No, you have nothing to do with my history. It's
when
my
I
future.
Interview you, Frank, to work for. Job. I don't know
then
you as a human
then you
being.
You are discriminating.
As a human being, tell me your life story.
If I gave you the ability to fire people, then you could be as discriminating as you want.
So you got out of prison last week.
You're encouraging discrimination if you don't allow people to fire people.
No, you got out of prison last week after serving 20 years for a double murder. Now, you did your time, so the law says you're excused. But I can't. You don't tell me that when you apply for the job. Eric's sitting right next to you, applies for the same job. You have similar qualities. And for whatever reason, it's a tie, and I give it to you over Eric. How is that fair to Eric? Because I didn't even know.
How's that fair to
Eric? I didn't even know that information about you.
That information doesn't matter about me.
Had I known you just got out of prison for committing murder, I wouldn't have hired you. I would have hired
him. Then you are discriminating.
Because, no, all things were not equal, but you weren't telling me the part that I should know as I make my decision.
It has nothing to do with you.
It's like a jury doesn't get to know that you murdered 15 people. You know what I'm saying?
That has nothing to do with
you. It's the same thing, Frank. It's your life story.
You can yell over me all you want. If I do the job as well as Eric, and from that moment, 2 weeks ago, I got let out of prison, you're never going to know. If I keep doing the job and I do it well. Now, if you have the ability to fire me later because I'm a horrible employee, then you can hire Eric, fine. Well, but my history does not determine my future. Okay. At that particular point, you're only hiring Eric. Eric wins by default, and he's an idiot.
Well, I will say this.
I might be a better worker.
Your history does give me an insight into who you are as a human being.
And now I know who you are.
And let me decide if I want you on the payroll and on the company. And all things should be equal for all people sitting in front of me.
All things are equal because you're not being equal right now. You're discriminating against me from my past.
You're leaving out a whole chunk of your life.
That has nothing to do with you.
I can't even ask you about your life.
Why does that have anything to do with you?
Because you spent 20 years in prison for murdering people.
Let me interview my future employer.
I think the fact you're a convicted murdering felon is a relevant person. That tells me something about you as a human being.
You can argue all you want, but you're dead wrong.
Well, anyway,
you are discriminating.
The state law of California is the opposite of what I've said, and that honks me off. And I fought that.
You had a bad experience with a black person once, or a bad experience because a woman broke your heart. You're not hiring a black person or a woman based on your history. And I could say, oh, really? That's who you are? Okay, maybe I don't want to work for you then.
Heidi.
But I will say this, to Frosty's point, if what you're saying is true about not finding out that information, then you shouldn't know where I went to college. You shouldn't need to know any of that. You just bring me in and go, why are you qualified to do this job? So then if I'm not sharing that I've been in prison, then I shouldn't have to share that I where I went to school
exactly.
Or how much education I've had, because then it's not important.
You know, if you're going to do this interview process with someone you were just going to make a relationship with, in the dating process, you don't bring up double murder. I got let out of prison 2 weeks ago. No. And usually within the first, they say 10 seconds, 30 seconds, a woman knows she's going to sleep with you or not, or whatever that might be, the first impressions, love at first sight, all this other stuff. Yeah, in relationships, you're going to let that happen. So in an interview, I'm like, between you two, I'm like, am I going to hire Heidi or Frosty? I'm like, well, you know what? I felt something about Heidi. I don't know what it was, some gut feeling. I'm just going to go with that. And hopefully I made the right choice. And if she's a horrible employee, like I said, if I had the ability to fire her, fine. Then I still have your number. I can call you up. Maybe I made a mistake at that point. If I'm basing on your histories that have nothing to do with this job, then that's discrimination.
No, your resume shows your qualifications.
Okay. I'm right.
But
you're
in this case, you're leaving some bad stuff off.
You're absolutely wrong.
Okay, one more sentence. My family had a small business. We had a couple of small music stores in Indiana.
And it went out of business. But whatever.
That's because I went off to do it.
Because you wouldn't hire that black guy who was excellent.
So if I was a business owner like my dad was.
Guy lifted a piano on his back.
And I'm going to hire someone to work next to my children and my wife. And I should be able to know if you just got out of prison for murdering people.
You just said that.
That's what I'm saying again.
You said it four times now.
You're denying
me
as an employer for making...
Let's go to Judy. Hello, Judy.
Hey, you guys. Good morning. No offense, Frank. I kind of agree with Frosty, though I do think...
Hello, Samuel. You know what? Based on her past, the past four words she said, I know her call's going to suck, so I hung up.
See how you are?
See what I mean?
See?
I'm just like you now.
I wouldn't have done that.
I'm just like you now.
I would have let her continue.
Based on her opinion, I know she's an idiot, so I hung up on her.
That's an assumption.
But on the first four words.
You don't know.
You're assuming, too, about this guy. You're assuming he's going to murder you and everybody else in the job.
I think she was brilliant.
I proved my point
right there. Well, we'll never know now, will we? Because we didn't get
to... Now you agree with me.
No, you agree with me.
Are you kidding?
You stopped her from telling her entire...
Because obviously she's an idiot based on her first four words.
You're assuming the resume shows the truth.
Now it's history.
You don't know.
Sorry. I win. Samuel.
Yeah, hi.
If you want to get this job, you know what to say.
See? He's got the button. With the button comes power.
I'm the boss. Hello, Samuel.
Mm-hmm. Hey, I just wanted to remind you that these people that you're talking about, the unfireables, the crazies, the people that get in there and, you know, you can't fire them. Now, these people are the minority. Like, the majority of the working class people are out there day to day, and they know how expendable they are. And that in itself causes a bunch of anxiety. You know, when you're working an hourly rate and you have, you know, you have your car insurance through, your health insurance, your vision, your dental, and they let you know how expendable you are when you sign the contract. They're at-will employers, which means they could fire you at any time for any reason. It makes your life, like, a stress. It's
it
almost
makes
like
you
being
work.
An indentured surgeon. Yeah, well, yeah, it does make you work, but you better be good at your fucking job. Oh.
Okay, you're language,
you just got fired from the phone.
Right. Yeah, we're going to have to let you go.
Yeah, we're going to have to let you go. We did. Because you can't use the phone correctly on the radio. 1-800-955-5567 is the number. Lisa, let's see what's going on in traffic right now.
Traffic report is brought to you by Southern California Edison. Sigler canceled the 60 at Grand. All lanes there are open. Westbound on the 60 at the 605. No lanes blocked, but grews, some people are doing landscaping work along the right shoulder, and that is slowing your drive down. West 10 at the 57. There's a stall in lanes. 91 westbound. Right at the 605, a wreck moved to the right shoulder. Pretty solid backup from the 5 freeway. And reports of police activity along the 405 northbound at Irvine Center Drive, so you'll see slowing there as well. Every year, metallic balloons cause power outages and safety hazards. Southern California Edison wants to help you and your family stay safe around electricity. Never release metallic balloons and make sure they're securely tied down. Stay aware, stay safe. That's traffic on 95.5 KLOS.
Are you paying too much for auto insurance? Visit AAA.com/insurance for a free quote and find out how much you could save. Find competitive rates on auto insurance through the Auto Club. Visit AAA.com/insurance today.
Top rocker Harley Davidson. If you want to get on a Harley, I suggest you go visit my dirty biker buddies and the friendly staff over there on Sherman Way in Canoga Park. Right now, if you buy a new 2017 Harley Davidson in the month of July, you pick your special package, that package being package one, riding gear package, package two, street cannon muffler package, or package three, the first service is on Top Rocker. And for zero down and $156 a month, they'll have you riding out on your own Iron 883. And tonight, no, not tonight, but the 20th, I'm so anxious for this. On the 20th of this month, this is Thursday, it's bike night from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. They're going to have a Tom Petty tribute band out there playing, dollar beers. It's going to be great. So head on out there. I said on Sherman Way in Canoga Park, Top Rocker, Harley Davidson. Take a test ride and get entered to win tickets to UFC 214. That's the big fight between John Jones, Daniel Cormier. So you take a test ride and get entered to win those tickets. Winners receive a pair of tickets to the event. Winners may also participate in a group ride from Top Rocker HD to the Honda Center for the fight, which would be awesome. So come in, meet the friendly staff and the Dirty Bikers, and always receive top dollar for your trade. They are open 7 days a week on Sherman Way in Canoga Park. Top Rocker Harley Davidson online at TopRockerHD.com.
The sound of refreshing, sparkling water. Mmm. The sound of discovering new flavors. 7-Eleven is the best place to taste it all. Stop by today for the bold new strawberry-flavored or new watermelon-flavored Perrier Sparkling Water. Zero calories, zero sweeteners, natural flavors. Grab two half-liter bottles for $2.50. Refreshing sparkling water. Delicious flavors. Mmm. And a great deal at participating 7-Eleven stores. Ends 8/29/17. Restrictions apply.
When sleeping is over and the day is about to begin.
Honey, we're running late. We're not gonna make it.
There's one place you can go to face the madness of morning.
Get to the shower!
McDonald's. Breakfast saves the day with delicious classics like an Egg McMuffin sandwich and hot, freshly brewed McCafe coffee. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Coming up on Frosty, Heidi, and Frank, brought to you by Southern California BMW Centers. The Walking Dead is filming again after the death of a stuntman. We'll have more details at 10 before the hour. For a limited time, lease the 2017 BMW X1 S-Drive 28i Special Edition for as low as $329 a month. See a Southern California BMW Center today for details or visit SoCalBMW.com.
Now, the KLOS Surf Report with Surf Junkie Jeff.
Good Tuesday morning, surf addicts. Well, it's looking like another day of mediocre energy. Those conditions are fairly clean out there with a minor mix of south swell and northwest energy. Most LA and OC beaches are pulling knee to waist high plus waves with the best combo spot stomach high with the occasional plus set. 6 this morning, tide pushed up to a 3.3 high and then drops to a 1.8 low. 11 later this morning. If you're going to get wet, that spring seal will do the job with that water temp between 68 and 70 degrees. I'm Surf Junkie Jeff, combing the coast on the Rock of Southern California, 95.5 KLOS.
95.5 KLOS and KLOS HD1, Los Angeles.
Summer is meant for kicking back and cutting loose. And your Toyota dealers are making it easy for you to get the most out of your summer with amazing offers on the entire lineup at the Summer Drive Sales Event. Head to the beach for some R&R in a fuel-efficient Camry or Prius. Take off to the mountains in a versatile RAV4 or powerful Tundra. Get the whole family together in a spacious Sienna or Highlander. Whatever your summer plans, your Toyota dealers make it easy.
Now it's easier than ever to search for the best deal on a Toyota car, truck, or SUV. Just visit buyatoyota.com, the only official site for your Southern California Toyota dealers. There, you can locate a dealer, search our inventory, and find the perfect car with all our current offers. Save time and money. Go direct to the source, buyatoyota.com.
We make it easy on you.
Toyota, let's go places.
Hey, remember the mortgage meltdown of 2008? Have you tried to get a mortgage since then and been turned down? Or maybe you haven't even tried because your credit score is stuck at 585 or your tax returns have too many write-offs. Well, Cash Call Mortgage has great news for you. We've just introduced programs for people who've been told no. And what's doubly exciting is that we can solve your mortgage problems with no closing costs, no points, title, escrow, and no fees.
Wait, Cash Call, are you saying you now have credit and income-solving mortgages with no closing costs? Are you kidding?
You heard right. A credit or income-solving loan with no closing costs. Call 877-890-CASH, and we'll work with you to solve your mortgage issues. Make the cash call at 877-890-CASH.
Impact Mortgage Corp., DBA Cash Call Mortgage, Equal Housing Lender. Call 855-657-9910 for terms and restrictions. California Department of Business Oversight Residential Mortgage Lender Law License 4131083, NMLS 128231.
That's 877-890-CASH.
Are you hiring? Join the over 3 million businesses that use Indeed.com for hiring. Post your next job opening on the world's number one job site, Indeed.com.
Hi, AccidentLawyer.com. Settlement news. $1.5 million for bicyclists struck by a limo suffering serious ankle injury.
Hi, Accident Lawyer is the way to go. Call 800-920-0810.
Robert Koenig, Esquire. Results may vary. No guarantee.
Presenting a set for life story starring...
Insert your name here.
There you are on your...
Insert dream adventure.
Suddenly, your guide points. Behind some trees is a...
Insert special dream animal.
You quickly snap a...
Insert dream selfie.
Then you, your selfie, and special dream animal go viral. Live your wildest realities with $20,000 a month for 25 years. Play Set for Life Scratchers from the California Lottery. Please play responsibly. Must be 18 or older to play.
Mike Thompson RV presents KLOS Rockin' RV Summer Savings this Friday through Sunday.
2017 Keystone Springdale 282 Travel Trailer, only $149 a month at KLOS Rockin' RV Summer Sale at MikeThompson.com.
$19,341, 25% down, 144 months, 4.5% APR, approved credit expires 7/23/17.
This is the sound of a large Coke at McDonald's. And that is the sound of our straw going into the Coke. And now that any size Coke is only a dollar all summer long, this is the sound of someone taking a long sip. And if you think that sounds good, how about any small McDonald's smoothie, frappe, or shake for $2? Now top that. Ooh, whipped topping only at McDonald's. A la carte only. Limited time offer at participating McDonald's. Cannot be combined with any other offer or any combo meal.
Hello.
Hi, Veronica. I'm a helpful Southern California Honda person, and I'm calling to give you a random act of helpfulness.
That would be awesome.
We heard your boyfriend could use some new work boots.
Yeah, he works in construction, and he has a really bad back and knees, and he needs these certain boots, but they're really expensive. Oh. He has 5 kids of his own, and when we started dating, he also took on my 5 kids. Wow. He'll do anything to make sure all the kids have what they need, and he never thinks of himself.
Well, Honda would like to help. We're going to get your boyfriend 3 brand new pairs of boots.
Oh my gosh, that would be so awesome.
Today, we helped a hardworking dad get the boots he needs. And during the Honda Summerbration sales event, we can help you with a great deal. Because right now, we're clearing out the 2017s, like the 2017 HR-V, winner of 2017 U.S. News Best Subcompact SUV for the money. Visit SoCalHondaDealers.com to find the helpful Honda dealer near you. Veronica is a real person and was paid to be on the radio. View U.S. News Best Cars at usnews.com/cars.
Just for our neighbors, Universal Studios Hollywood brings you the new California Neighbor Pass. For the neighborly price of just $129 online, you get over 175 days in the park. There's nothing quite like it. So swing by, grab a refreshing Coca-Cola, and share some laughs with your neighbors. Or grab a quick bite with Homer Simpson.
Donuts.
Race the streets with Dom Toretto.
Let's go for a little ride.
Or lend a hand to your Transformers friends.
Protect the Allspark.
Come enjoy everything around the neighborhood, including Transformers The Ride 3D. Because after you see the new movie, you'll want to join Optimus Prime and Bumblebee in a thrill ride that puts you in the middle of the greatest battle ever. Then you'll be ready to cool off with an ice-cold Coca-Cola. Visit UniversalStudiosHollywood.com to get over 175 days of thrills, laughter, and wonder with a California Neighbor Pass for $129 online. Why? Because that's what neighbors do. So grab a refreshing Coca-Cola, grab your friends, and get going. Pass valid for 9 months from select first visit date. Blackout dates and restrictions apply.
Ram 1500 does more than stand the test of time. It stands up to anything you throw at it or in it because of its active level 4-corner air suspension. This summer, check out America's longest lasting pickups at the Ram Summer Clearance Event.
Available feature based on IHS Automotive VIO registration data for all brands of GVW 1-3 pickup trucks continuously sold in the U.S. since 1988. Dodge and Ram have the highest overall percentage still on the road. Ram is a registered trademark of FCA US LLC.
Live from the Morongo Casino Studios, it's Frosty, Heidi, and Frank on 95.5 KLOS and KLOS HD1.
Frosty, Heidi, and Frank show. Time for the Metallica song of the day, which you need to be listening for. If you want to go see Metallica at the Rose Bowl on July 29th and be in the running for the new KLOS Metallica Dodge Charger, all you have to do is listen between 3:30 and 4 this evening for the song Turn the Page. Now, when you hear it, be caller 25 at 800-955-5567, and then you're going to see Metallica at the Rose Bowl on July 29th and be in the running for that damn Dodger.
Frank, you know how you Dodge, know you're getting Dodge, old?
Charger,
you said
Charger,
between 3:30 and 4 is this evening.
Oh, my God, I know.
You've crossed, crossed over, Frank. No. There's no turning back.
Just
that's now late.
And the early
late night tonight at 3:30 p.m. I'll be long gone to sleep. But you have a chance. Turn the page. Talking about getting employed as a felon and being able to turn the page on that.
Ah.
Turn the page on your history of crime. Start your life over again and be a productive citizen in society. Frosty says you can't move forward.
Turn the page worked for Bob Seger. But as a convicted felon, if you're coming in to apply for work, and I can't discuss, I can't even ask you if you're convicted felon. You know, there's a box you used to check on the application. Check here if convicted felon. That's gone now. See, that seems like an entire huge, massive, big, major part of your life was spent in prison for some terrible crimes. Now, suddenly, that isn't relevant and doesn't count, and I can't ask you about that?
I'm with Frosty.
Well, see, I know you're with Frosty, but like I said, I've talked to people who hire people, and they say 1 in 20 come in, and then 19 of them are idiots. And that one person that comes in, and you've been interviewing people all day, and you're frustrated, you got to fill this spot because your boss needs you to fill that spot. And all the other employees that you have that are working have to fill in that other spot and take extra hours. And everybody's getting tired and burned out. You got to hire somebody, and the one in the 20 happens to be a convicted felon. You know what? He gets the job.
Well, I guess what I'm thinking about with Frosty, and maybe I'm going more and not in a corporate level, but in a level where I'm personally hiring somebody. If you're going to hire a nanny, do you want to know if that nanny spent any time in jail for anything?
Exactly point.
She or he is going to be with your kids, and you're like, I need to know your background. Have you ever?
First off, I'm a hands-on parent. I'm not some lazy parent who hires nannies.
I don't parent
how you do, Heidi. Okay, you want to go out and do your drinking and all that other stuff.
Yeah,
I'm going to be home raising my kids.
Even if you did a crime, and if you are a felon and spent time, you know, we can still talk about it. Doesn't mean I'm not going to hire you. But to not even discuss that, dude, what'd you do? Tell me what happened.
There's some texts coming in, and they're saying, okay, Frank, is it okay with pedophiles who serve their time working at elementary school?
Right, or Nan, there's some stuff that you're going to need to know.
Well, I think on the personal level, I can ask you that as a nanny. I'm not a corporation. It's like you're going to follow my corporate rules of applications. I think I can ask you on a personal level. You're going to be in my house. You're going to be cleaning my house or cutting my grass.
Mm-hmm.
It's my responsibility at that point. Personal safety.
Labor code.
When it comes to corporate stuff, then yes. Do I want a pedophile working at elementary school? Well, if I was president, pedophiles would be shot in the head.
Right.
They wouldn't be going out and getting jobs after they got out because pedophiles wouldn't be getting out. They'd be dead. Bang, bang.
But I think it's a, as a boss of a corporation, if it's safety.
Kramer 2020. You can fire whoever you want and pop, pop pedophiles.
I like the pop, pop pedophile.
It's the new wing. It's the new wing of the Republican Party or something. I don't know what it is.
But I think as a boss in a corporation, your employees are also, you got to worry about their personal safety as well, right? You've got all these people.
That's going to be a weird bumper sticker, pop, pop, pedophile.
Yeah. Catchy, though.
What could that mean?
You know, people be cutting out the pop, pop and screwing you, you know, when you're trying to support it.
Yeah. Dang it, you played a trick on me.
And think mom and pop business, honey, a little small business, your family might work there, you know, you trust
mom,
and everything.
Mom, pop, pedophile. You said family business.
Yeah. Mom,
okay.
Pop,
pop. Can I give you the most boring sentence of the day, but it needs to be stuck right here, otherwise people are going to call and clog the phones and go, yeah, here we go. Labor Code Section 432.9 says, criminal history information can still be requested on the initial employment application for law enforcement positions, positions working with children, the elderly or disabled, and other sensitive positions, and criminal backgrounds can be conducted at the discretion of the employer. Now, that's for those specific things. But if you're just a mom-and-pop shop, running a radio shack or whatever.
If you're running a radio shack.
You got bigger problems.
Yeah, what are you doing?
How are you hiring anybody?
Right. You can hire a pedophile to not sell batteries.
You're going to have to fire mom, Pop. All right.
Pop, mom.
Let's go to Jed. Hey, Jed.
Hey.
How you doing, man?
I'm good, thank you.
What's your opinion about this?
Frank Army all the way.
That's right.
Well, Frosty, you're out on this one. I got two felons that work for me. Great employees, dedicated. It's, as Frank said, not about how you used to live your life. What are the choices you are willing to make in the future? I had another guy that worked in the military, showed up. This guy didn't even know how to use an effing ratchet strap.
Come on, who does? I mean, even I know
my
that.
God.
He's bagging on the military. Well, I'm not going to go there.
But
hey, by the way,
figure, in the military, you figure you'd hire him. Military guy versus felon guy. This military guy, you think, knows how to use a ratchet strap.
Okay, there's bad talk show hosts, too. Not everyone in an occupation is brilliant.
Enough about yourself.
Stop it.
All right, really, it's not always about you, dude.
Felons turned out to be good workers, but that's not the point. The point is initial application to leave out the fact that you are a felon. And whatever crimes you did isn't fair to the other guys who aren't felons and didn't do crimes if the playing field's supposed to be equal for everyone sitting in front of me applying for a job. They get to tell me their whole life story, but I can't include...
But you're making it unequal by asking this. I'm saying, I mean, you're arguing for equality, but you're saying, let's tilt the field for people who haven't been convicted felons.
I'm
if it's all equal, then you... See, if it's not equal, all you're going to ask... benign questions, that's not going to ruin it for anybody. It's all about the qualifications of the job. It has nothing to do with anything else outside the job. That's an equal playing field, and it has to be like The Voice, where your back is to them during the interview.
No.
And they all have to be
it's
disguised
not like
voices.
It's like Voice somehow. I don't know how it's not.
I've been working in the military.
And then you turn your chair around, right. If you're going to hire them or not.
Possible hire number two. I mean, you wouldn't ask about the military.
Yeah, I know how to use a ratchet strap.
Okay, maybe that.
Just asking everybody to know how to use a ratchet.
What is a ratchet strap?
Okay, well, excuse you, number three.
Could we get off the freaking ratchet strap?
I'm just saying.
I can see
the
ratchet
strap.
You can have the ratchet strap point. Frank, I didn't tilt the playing field.
What?
The criminal did. You did a crime. You chose to do something really bad. You're a felon. You went to prison. You did that, not me. Now suddenly I can't even, that isn't part of your life. You don't get to expunge that when you come in and want me to hire you. It's a significant part of who you were.
So every sentence is a life sentence.
It's like who you were, Frank. Where did you go to college?
Every sentence is a life sentence.
No, it's part of your life story.
Then you
story.
Make no sense
Frank,
whatsoever.
I may say, hey, it's cool. I understand. What did you do, man? What happened? Tell me your story. You went to prison. What happened? Maybe are you fine now? Okay, cool. But to act like it didn't happen... That's not right. It did happen. Just like this guy went
to
college.
So I'm getting ready to work for a guy who has crimes that he'll say it's okay to commit, and crimes he'll say it's absolutely not okay to commit.
Well, there's
I stole
spectrum.
A car. Okay, who hasn't?
Hey, who has, okay.
You got caught. I didn't.
Frank, you did third strike, shoplifting, you stole the pizza, whatever, fine. But triple homicide, murder, rape, pillage,
you
sodomy.
You hire a guy whose third strike was stealing a slice of pizza?
Yes.
Then you're an idiot. I'd never hire that guy. That was his third strike.
Over the pillager.
He stole a slice of pizza he knew was his third strike. Idiot. I'm not hiring him. He's a moron.
But Frosty can understand.
You
pizza.
Would?
Good pizza.
Jesus.
You got a serial sodomizer
mind.
Over here. It's third strike pizza guy over
Let's
there.
Go to Jason.
I'm
Hello.
With pizza guy.
Hello, Jason. Of course you're with the pizza guy. Hello, Jason.
Hey, how are you, bud?
What's up, man?
Good morning, guys. Okay, well, the reason I was calling is I was kind of just weighing in on what you guys were talking about earlier about, you know, stress leave and things like that, and I had it my ex-wife, her and her lover broke up, and, you know, she took time off. She took 2 weeks stress leave off of work. They called it personal life stress leave. And she took 2 weeks off of work for that.
I think you're more irritated, not because she got the stress leave. It's because she had to take it for her ex-boyfriend.
No, it was for her ex-girlfriend.
Ew.
Oh.
Wow.
Yeah, no irritation, guys. None whatsoever.
So do you think if she dumped you, she'd also take stress leave or not?
Well, no, since her and I split up, you know, mutually, I don't think that would ever happen.
I think I'd be insulted if I didn't bother you enough, you needed to take time off work. What did I mean to you? Nothing?
It didn't bother me at all. Moving on.
How dare you?
I was back at work the next day.
Former lesbians are so dramatic. Thank you, Jason. All right, let's go to Jonathan. Hello, Jonathan.
What's going on, guys? How you doing?
What's up, man?
So why not have something set up to where people could be hired, whether or not they're Fallon or not, and have like a probation period? That's pretty equal. So if you have like a 90-day probation for people who are just newly hired, that 90 days is going to tell you whether or not they're a good worker.
That's a great idea.
But anybody can work hard for 90 days.
Yeah, the smart thief waits 91 days.
Oh.
Plus, well, couldn't you abuse that 90 days too?
There's a good chance that if that person is lazy, they're going to be late or they're going to mess up in that 90 days.
Yeah, they can't mess up once in 90 days.
But then you could abuse that too. You could say, okay, you know what you're going to do? You're going to do this and this and this. It's almost like hazing for 90 days. And if they can make it through the 90 days, then you hire them. So you could almost, you know, Every 90 days, hire somebody new to do all the dirt work. Yeah, you never hire a permanent employee.
That was a terrible idea, Jonathan. The worst I've ever heard.
You're fired.
Probably a felon, that one.
All right. Hello, Austin.
Yes.
What's up, man?
How you doing?
Pretty good.
And you?
How's the weather where you are?
I'm doing fantastic.
Dog's okay?
It's okay. Hi, everybody. How you doing?
You're fired.
You're fired, Austin. See? Doesn't matter about his history.
I'm with you on this one, Frank.
We're
yes.
all on the
I
same.
Don't care.
We are in agreement.
He's fired. Hello, Paul.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Paul.
Man, it's been a while. So my boss, he was interviewing multiple people, and he interviewed two guys named John and accidentally hired the wrong guy. He hired a felon. And when he showed up to work the first day, he realized his mistake, but he was too embarrassed to not let this guy work. So he ended up working for us. Best employee we've ever had. He was the hardest worker and did anything we asked. And
yeah, he was hiring a felon's like dating a fat girl.
What do you mean?
They work hard.
Try harder.
Yeah. Can't just rely on, you know, those old fallbacks.
You almost swore there.
I almost did.
Paul, I'm going to give you a prize for that.
Awesome.
I'm going to give you, let's see, can you go to Comic-Con down in San Diego this weekend sometime?
I could, yeah.
All right, I'm going to give you a day pass? What do I have here?
Awesome.
San Diego Convention Center, Comic-Con. There you go, buddy. You got a pair of tickets.
Sweet, thanks a lot.
Stan Holberg.
I'm glad in Paul's story, the felon guy turned out to be a good employee. I think, Frank, you may misunderstand what I'm saying, as you always do.
I think you're now realizing what you said.
I'm not saying convicted felons can't be great employees and get their life together. I hope they have. I hope they have. But if I'm going to look at everyone's resume and their life's history, starting with high school, what have you done since high school? Tell me your story. Did you go to school? Where have you worked? What have you done? There's a big chunk of your life you spent in prison for a crime. You're leaving that out, see? That doesn't make it fair to everyone else who just has to tell me their whole life story. Now, it doesn't mean just because you went to prison for something, I'm not going to hire you and give you a chance, but let's talk about it.
Tells me you're a go-getter.
Let's talk about it.
I suppose the boring guy who did nothing.
If you're an overachiever and you convince me of that because you know you got your life together out of prison, good for you.
A guy who went to prison or a guy who lived in his mother's basement and never moved out? And still lives in his mother's basement.
Well, I mean, there's stories for both of those guys. I'd like to hear both
Which
stories.
Which one would you hire?
Well, that's not
the story.
That's not a story. It's a headline.
Convicted felon. Guys, I mean, talking about their life story. Oh, I've lived in my mom's basement and I graduated high school, and I'm really good at Call of Duty.
I'm not going to blanket judge either one. I want to know why you're still living with mom, and I want to know why you're a convicted felon.
I murdered two people. I'm really good at Call of Duty. Well, what do you got?
I'm probably with the guy living with mom. Well, murderer. Murderer!
Yeah, but you know what? The guy living in his mother's basement may have murdered two people and just never got caught.
Oh, yeah?
He could be just as creepy.
Well, that's a woulda, coulda, shoulda. You know what?
If he had a 27 kill streak on Call of Duty once.
I'm going with the felon on that.
I'm going with the felon on that, too. At least he left the house. My God, this guy's a weirdo.
But you're assuming. If ifs and buts were candy and nuts, we'd all have a Merry Christmas. But they're not, and we don't. Or something.
I smell a new t-shirt.
I dare you to argue with that one.
I smelled your Christmas list. What is that?
Take notes.
Get the hell out of here.
It's actually a quote from Colby on Survivor Season 2.
Really?
Credit where credit's due. Colby Donaldson.
The fact that's part of your story means I would never hire you.
I'm going with the felon.
I'm going with the felon. The guy who quotes Colby in the audition. All right, how much time we got? I know we're late in this passionate discussion about hiring and firing. So much time we got, Eric?
We got like 2 minutes.
Oh, two more minutes, so we can take a couple more calls. Let's go to Stephanie. Hello, Stephanie.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Good.
Good. I was just going to say, like Heidi just said, you know, the difference between one applicant and the other is one got caught and one didn't. And then on top of that, too, okay, so say the one did get caught and they served their time in jail. In California jail systems, what are we doing for these people to help rehabilitate those behaviors that are in them? So it really doesn't matter whether they serve jail time or not.
She's saying it doesn't matter if somebody's been to jail or not, because you never know what anybody's done anyway. Some people just get caught and some people
didn't. So you're assuming everyone's done something that's prison-worthy, they just haven't been caught
probably
yet?
Probably.
Like the guy Frank said who's stealing with mom? Doesn't mean he's a bad, creepy, weird felon.
Well, no, like I said, going back to the relationship issue, you don't reveal all of your dirty laundry and the things that are bad about you on your first couple of dates, trying to get it. Once you fall in love with me and we establish, you know, that we're with each other and nobody else, and then, you know, and things start getting out about me, you're going to learn those things about me over time. And eventually you could fire me from this relationship if you want to, because I'm not the guy that you thought I was when we first started dating. But that's, you always hold something back. In the interview, Frosty, they're asking your story. You're not going to be 100% honest.
Well,
I'm never
going
to hire a guy. Maybe I'd hire you as a delivery guy because you used to drive your girlfriend to get laid by another guy at their house. I mean, that's commitment to delivery.
I'm great behind the wheel.
I would hire you for FedEx or Uber Eats or something like that. You deliver.
I get an A+ for hurting myself. Can I do that on your payroll?
But Frank, yeah, anything else I wouldn't hire you for.
My last gasp at trying to get you to come over to my side. Let's say, hypothetically, Frank, you were a terrible radio employee. Couldn't even say the word radio.
is that ironic? How bad you were. I know you like ironic stuff. Is that ironic?
So perfect.
And let's say over a stretch of, say, I don't know, 15 to 20 years, you've been fired repeatedly. You've screwed up all the time.
This is hypothetical.
firing was a big, huge chunk of your life story for reasons. What doesn't matter, you were fired and you lost your job several times in radio. Now you come to apply for me and I'm Mr. King Radio Guy. And you don't mention any of that. You leave it off. And I can't ask you if you ever fired in radio. That's against the law. That doesn't seem like it's giving me a true picture of who you are as a human being and how you might perform in my company. That doesn't seem right. Let's tell the whole story.
Yeah, and if you were a King Radio Guy, you know if you'd never been fired in radio, you haven't really tried. I mean, you haven't really done radio. You're not good at your job. You've never been fired.
That's true.
You'd be fired. Yeah. If you're looking to hire somebody who's never been fired in radio?
Yeah, okay.
Good luck, KABC. Lisa May, what's going on in traffic right now?
Traffic report is brought to you by AccountTemps. A Sig Alert issued in Malibu for Kane and Doom Road, just north of Pacific Coast Highway. Both lanes closed for about an hour because of an accident, so look for big delays there. There's a crash in the fast lane on the 10 westbound around Citrus. That has you slow from Kellogg Hill. On the Pasadena Freeway, the 110 southbound around Stadium Way, an accident in lanes. On the 405 southbound at Golden West in Orange County, a wreck with a bike in the carpool lane. Traffic is slow from Westminster Boulevard, and the 5 southbound is heavy from the 22 down to Red Hill. That's a stall in the middle lane. Finding highly skilled accounting and finance professionals can be a challenge. Let AccountTemps help. With AccountTemps' extensive network of accounting and finance candidates, you can be sure to find the professional with the skills for your hiring needs. Visit AccountTemps.com. AccountTemps, a Robert Half company. That's traffic on 95.5 KLOS.
Are you paying too much for auto insurance? Visit AAA.com/insurance for a free quote and find out how much you could save. Find competitive rates on auto insurance through the Auto Club. Visit AAA.com/insurance today.
All right, let's imagine that you get into a car accident. Maybe you called an attorney, and that attorney is not Sweet James. In fact, it's somebody who's not sweet at all, and they're not doing anything on your case. They're not calling you back. They're not even talking to you. And you know what? It happens all the time. You get an attorney who takes your case and then seems to completely forget about you. Maybe you're thinking, great, I'm stuck. too late to change? No, it's not too late to change. The call you need to make is to my pal, the dense beard of justice, sweet James Bergner. That's all you got to do. Just pick the wrong guy. That doesn't mean you can't make a change. It's never too late to get the right attorney, and that is sweet James. It's easy. Just call him. Call James. Talk to him. Give him the lowdown on your case and tell him what's going on. Then he's going to worry about breaking up with that other lawyer. That's the best thing about it. You don't have to make an awkward breakup call. It's not you. It's me. He'll do all that for you. Call him. He'll send him a letter. Make sure they never call you again. He's going to take your file, and he will get to work on everything immediately and get you the best result that you need. He is the best in the business. Hopefully you never need his phone number. Why not put it in your phone in case you do need it? 800-881-2021. 800-881-2021. You can also check him out online at sweetjames.com.
What does the E in the all-new BMW 530e iPerformance stand for? Efficient. Its plug-in hybrid powertrain allows you to power your drive using all gas, all electric, or an intelligent combination of both. Exhilarating. eBoost provides an instant acceleration that can get you ahead of the crowd. Engaging. For the ability to upload directions or precondition the cabin climate remotely from your phone. But it's truly the combination of sleek looks, powerful performance, and an array of innovative features that makes the E in the BMW 530e nothing short of extraordinary. Head to your local BMW center and experience the extraordinary in a BMW 530e iPerformance. BMW, the ultimate driving machine.
The BMW 530e iPerformance is now eligible for single-occupant HOV lane access and a $1,500 CVRP rebate. Visit SoCalBMW.com.
Are you living with depression? Are you having trouble controlling it with your current medication? If you answered yes to both of those questions, you are not alone. According to the National Institute of Mental Health, major depression affects approximately 7% of adults. And the journal Patient Preference and Adherence reports an estimated 10 to 30% of patients with major depression do not respond to typical antidepressant medications. Right now, there's a clinical research study in your area, and you may qualify to participate. The purpose of this study is to determine if an investigational medication, given as a nasal spray, is safe and effective for patients who have not responded to prior treatment. Those who qualify will receive the study medication, study-related medical exams, and laboratory tests at no cost. Compensation for time and travel may also be available. To find out if you qualify, call the study site at 833-878-8878. That's 833-878-8878. Call now, 833-878-8878.
Is this the Oasis pool? I think I left my custom beach towel there. It's the one with my face on it.
Your top reasons to visit Morongo.
Enjoy a world of flavors at Potrero Canyon Buffet.
Number two.
All you can eat crab and shrimp Wednesday and Thursday in the buffet.
And the number one reason to go to Morongo Casino Resort and Spa this week.
You'll also love the lobster and steak buffet on Fridays and Saturdays.
Morongo, good times.
Go, go, go. O'Reilly.
If your vehicle isn't stopping like it used to, visit O'Reilly Auto Parts for the Summer Break Deals event. Take advantage of the O'Reilly Auto Parts Do It Right rebate and get a $25 O'Reilly gift card by mail when you buy a set of Brake Best Select pads and a pair of rotors. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day. Limits apply. See store for details.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Once upon an OC time, when crops thrived in the sun, a farmer's book showed us the way to harvest farm fresh fun. It started on a crazy ride on roller coaster vines. Next thing you knew, it looped you through spun cotton candy skies. The chickens made their way up high, tied to flying balloons. Good eats were hatching left and right. Live music played in tune. The OC Fair's now back in town, and with it, farm fresh fun. There's rides, there's food, beer tasting too. It's all under the sun. Round up your friends and look ahead. Good times you'll come to spend. The OC Fair won't be here long. It's fresh fun till the end.
Brought to you by your Southern California Toyota dealers. The OC Fair runs from July 14th through August 13th. Visit ocfair.com.
iAccidentLawyer.com scores again. $700,000 for a passenger in a car hit by a tow truck suffers injury.
iAccidentLawyer is the way to go. Call 800-920-0810.
Robert Koenig, Esquire. Results may vary. No guarantee.
Make the most of your summer at the Hollywood Bowl with a spectacular lineup of music under the stars. The iconic Indiana Jones swings into action at Raiders of the Lost Ark in concert August 4th and 5th. Relive the magic of this swashbuckling adventure on the Bowl's big screen in HD with one of composer John Williams' best love scores performed live by the Los Angeles Philharmonic. Get your tickets now at HollywoodBowl.com. Hollywood Bowl, where summer plays.
There's no secret handshake to get in, but you do need to know the battle cry. So you'll need Dodge Challenger, the most affordable V8 in its class, or Dodge Charger with an available best-in-class 485 horsepower. Welcome to the Brotherhood of Muscle at the Dodge Summer Clearance Event. Based on latest available competitive information and Ward's middle specialty vehicle segmentation, based on Ward's large regular car vehicle segmentation, excludes other FCA US LLC vehicles. Dodge is a registered trademark of FCA US LLC.
As people retire or get close to retiring, many worry about making their money last. That's why you can't afford to miss this free Money Matters Retirement Seminar in Orange, 7 p.m. Thursday, Hilton Hotel, Anaheim. Reserve now at moneymatters.net. That's moneymatters.net.
This day in Rock 2001, the band Kiss released the Kiss Casket, an actual coffin featuring the faces of the band members. Endorsing the item, Gene Simmons said, "I love living, but this makes the alternative look pretty damn good."
The all-new BMW 530 EI Performance, now eligible for single-occupant HOV lane access and a $1,500 CVRP rebate. See a Southern California BMW center for details or visit SoCalBMW.com.
This Day in Rock brought to you by your Southern California BMW centers.
It's Frosty, Heidi, and Frank on the Rock of Southern California.
95.5 KLOS.
Plus, Eddie and Frank show. Guess we'll have to agree to disagree, Frosty. Difference of opinion.
As
you
always.
See it one way, I see it the other way. You see it black, I see it white. So,
fine. And I extend a handshake and say, let's have a beer later. It's just the way the government should work. It's the way it works in this room.
Mm-hmm. But there is a subject you think that we would all agree on, and that is the subject of cheating and what people consider cheating. And they did a survey. They asked people in Europe what they consider cheating, and Americans what they consider cheating in a relationship.
I bet it's a different definition.
Yeah, it's somewhat different. Like, would you say, show of hands in studio, and if you're out there playing along, driving to work or at home, stick your hand outside the window if you agree that vaginal intercourse, is it cheating?
I'm going to put the hand up on
hands up. Lisa's looking at me like, that's up. Is this really, are you being serious? Are you starting out with the easiest one?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, Sammy's saying no. everybody in the room has a hand in the air. Okay, so they ask Americans, is vaginal intercourse cheating? For women, 99% said yes. So 1%, the Sammy out there, said,
I don't see it.
I mean, we weren't in love.
Now, men, 97% of men. What is the argument? Well, so you're good at coming up with arguments, ridiculous arguments. The 3% that are arguing that vaginal intercourse isn't cheating, what is the argument?
I'm guessing that 1 or 3% don't speak English and didn't understand the question.
They just say, yes.
It's only cheating if I do it with an ex-felon.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to bring it back.
Don't try to bring it back.
Never have done, ever.
Is there that little sliver of us out there?
Sliver.
That little 1, 2, 3 out of every 100 people who's sort of a hippie mentality where there's no such thing as commitments and, we can all have orgies and such.
It's like sex.
Maybe the 3% are open relationships.
Yeah, those people.
But I thought open relationships meant, we swing and maybe we have to be in the same room. There's still rules in open relationships, right? Or else
they're still cheating.
You're just friends with benefits and you don't care if they go off and have vaginal intercourse with somebody else because there's no commitment. So then you can't cheat if there's no commitment.
So then that wouldn't
be cheating. This is implying a committed relationship if cheating can exist.
I don't get it.
All right. Mm-mm. How about this? Oral.
Hands up. Yes.
Hands up. Everybody except Sammy. All right. Let me go back to vaginal intercourse real quick.
You always want to. You always. You shouldn't.
Oh, yeah.
Be careful with that.
Moral back. All right. They asked Europeans about the whole vaginal intercourse thing. Obviously, for Americans, it was 99% for women, 97% for men. Europeans, 85% of women, and 81% of men.
There you go.
Well, I just do her. I do not love her. You know, I only do that. But
or is it okay, like the acceptance of mistresses, where it's like, yeah, you know, I don't want to do him anymore. It's not cheating because I know about it, and he can have his girl over there. I don't care. It's not cheating.
But I still need him to come home, and we've got a family life, and you know, he's
you know, the European mentality of mistresses. It's like, okay,
so as long as it's not an affair with feelings and attractions, if it means something, it's cheating, right?
Right. Like,
if it's just a frivolous,
I'll never see her again. It was a one-off. You can do. Some people have rules that, like, you're going to do that. You can't do it with the same person twice because then you could get feelings. But it's like, oh, you do.
So if my heart isn't attached, honey, here in Italy or wherever,
I mean,
it means nothing. She means nothing to me, so it's not cheating.
I don't get
it. Even though we did everything.
Everything.
It meant nothing to me.
All right, now let's get back to oral.
Okay.
We all raised our hands in here, except for Sammy. 97% of women say it's cheating, 96% of men.
Okay, so they're closer on that than they are with vaginal.
In
Europe,
weird. 83% of women, 78% of men say that's cheating.
Remember the Bill Clinton, Monica Lewinsky thing?
Yeah.
At that time, there was a discussion which a lot of people were having to have that didn't expect to have. What is cheating and what isn't? He was saying that wasn't.
That wasn't sex.
Well,
yeah, that's where his wording screwed up. No, it is sexual relations. Maybe it's not sex, but it's sexual relations. He goes, I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
And if oral isn't a sexual relation,
it is,
because
so
it's a sex.
Yeah.
If without relations, did you have sex with that woman? He could have said no.
Yes. Right.
Well, that's
for the vague definition of what is sex.
Under the umbrella of sex includes many things, and I think oral is under that umbrella. It's a sexual act.
Yes, it is.
Right?
Yeah.
Kissing you in the cheek.
I never had it under an umbrella.
He likes the rain pouring down on him.
Oh, come here, Rihanna.
Kissing your hand or kissing your cheek, Heidi, is not. But if we start involving our organs, I think that's under the sexual umbrella. It's a sexual act.
Don't jump ahead.
Okay, oh, all sorry. Right,
all right. All right, so up to anal now.
What?
Is that? Consider cheating, raise your hands.
Can't wait to hear the European numbers on this one.
Lisa went up on that one right away. Everybody except Sammy. Okay. For women in this country, 98% say anal is cheating. 95% of men say anal is cheating.
Oh, is that 5%?
In Europe, 81% of women and 76% of men.
Jeez.
So 1 in 4 almost over there.
Well, I think if you had to choose, Eric, that your lady is going to have sex with another man to save the country. Whatever reason
she's forced to cheat.
And you have to choose one or the other. Vaginal or anal?
Anal. Hands
there
down.
You go. Why?
Yeah. Because that's not my special place. My special place. Leave that alone.
There you go. So you wouldn't, it's less of a.
And I would be less mad invasion. If she came to me and said, I cheated, but it was backdoor.
Yeah,
I would feel a little less cheated on.
Oh, thank God.
Because chances are there was no romance there. There was no eye contact.
Oh, that's mean, Heidi, to say there can't possibly be any romance with anal.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Haven't you seen
There's
Deliverance?
A whole community out there. You just slam your
saying,
own.
No. I'm thinking of straight sex right now. There's
what, because gays can't cheat?
Well, I think gays do it missionary style that way. So you do
it's
have
so
eye
anal.
Contact. You do, but you do have eye contact. I think when men and women, I think the whole point of a guy wanting that with a girl is because it's like from behind. It's that view.
Yeah,
it's not missionary.
When I think gay sex, I think romantic.
No, but
did you ever see?
It's always missionary. Come
Brokeback
on, really?
Mountain.
You got to be kidding me.
I think
they're all guys.
Heidi, are you trying
no,
to say
there's no romance involved?
No, but
if there's eye contact. Eye contact makes it a whole other level.
I think so. I think eye to eye contact and kissing while doing it is way more intimate and romantic.
So obviously, when someone says anal's not cheating, they're not picturing the eye contact Heidi is, because 81% of women and 76% of men in Europe say it's not cheating.
Well, there could be a mirror on the wall. They could be holding a mirror.
Does that make it more romantic?
Well, eye to eye contact.
The bathroom mirror.
Oh, God.
All right, kissing.
Oh,
I really started at the top, didn't I?
You did.
kissing, is it cheating?
Yes.
Raise your hand if kissing's cheating.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what you're all thinking with tongue, since... Are you thinking with tongue?
Yeah.
It's not a peck on the forehead.
No, lip to lip.
Yeah, it's...
But no tongue. Cheating?
Yeah, sure.
Lip to lip, no tongue's not cheating. I don't think that's cheating. Kissing cheating?
I mean, yeah.
Tongue is cheating. Kissing on the lips is not.
I'm with you on that.
No, because you can do a lip kiss that where you linger. Where it's not a, oh, good to see you. It's, yeah, no tongue, but you can still do a sexy-ass kiss with no tongue. Oh, you know, yes.
Show me on Eric. It's his birthday.
No.
Eric, get over there. And
never.
No.
No.
It would be, you would be cheating.
I would be cheating.
A closed lip kiss on Eric would be cheating if you did it sexily or whatever you said.
Of course. Yes.
Are you wiggling your closed lips on each other or just bumping each other and holding
it? You're not talking about a kiss that you would kiss your grandmother. Like, all right, good. Mwah. That's not.
You never had a lingering kiss with your grandma?
Frank.
I know you have. That's why I didn't ask you.
It was a week ago Tuesday when I was on vacation. She died in 95.
Oh, my God.
Heidi and I had a kiss in acting class that was closed-lipped and it lingered for like 5 or 10 seconds.
Yeah.
Is that cheating?
No.
Or was it acting?
If I went home and had a honey poo, honey, what'd you do in acting class? Oh, I kissed this hot blonde wannabe actress chick.
Yeah.
How long? 10 seconds. Did you use tongue? No. Then
no,
it wasn't cheating.
No, it was very whiskery, though, I recall.
You or me? I was thinking the same.
Yeah, what were you kissing, Frosty?
I wasn't prepared for that class.
88% of women say kissing's cheating. So 12% don't think it is. 80% of men say kissing's cheating. In Europe, 78% of women and 66% of men. All right, heavy petting. Now, let's just define that. What is heavy petting?
Well, when you say heavy petting, that's
hugging like, with your arms moving?
Just
I don't know.
Bodily
Lisa
content.
May, what is heavy petting for you?
Well, I think that would be like inside the underwear.
Right.
Heavy petting is inside underwear?
Yes, because it's heavy petting, not just petting.
Yeah.
So what's outside the underwear?
Petting.
Petting.
Lisa, couldn't you be walling around all steamy with
dancing?
Yeah, making out.
Yeah.
And, yeah, making out. Just, you know,
But heavy petting means like
in
your
pants.
Yeah.
Heavy petting's in pants. I would have thought it's like more heavy groping over clothes. Like I might be going over your clothes, but you know I got a handful of that.
Yeah, I'm with Frank on that. I don't think you have to go under the cloth. Oh, it wasn't heavy petting because my finger didn't go in anything.
That's
heavy petting, I think, is like aggressive petting.
No, now you're comparing it to be really pushy.
No.
That's not what it means. It
heavy
just means
like...
All right, Eric, get over there. It's your birthday.
Yeah!
Heidi, heavy pet Eric. And then I'll heavy pet him the way I think it's
going. No.
No?
Heavy petting is the moment before the clothes
Sammy
get ripped
it.
Off,
She'll
right?
Do anything.
You stop just before the clothes come off. So that's just as sexual as a kiss
heavy
or
petting is what
else.
I imagine when you see in the movies... when the elevator doors close and they start making out pretty hard,
yes.
But they're standing up still, so they're like still feeling all over each other's bodies. And then, ding, they're like, "Okay, we're not making out."
Yeah,
but that's you have to get it in quick, and we got to make sure we know what we're doing here. You know what I mean? I'm all over you.
So
I don't have time to caress boobs and everything else.
No,
like,
that's fast petting.
Like,
that is not the same as heavy petting.
No, but I'm boobing, I'm assing, I'm crotching, I'm boobing, I'm assing, crotching, boobing, assing, crotching, and then we got to stop.
Fast can be heavy.
He's confusing speed and depth, if I may.
Right.
Fast petting can be heavy petting, and by the way, that is cheating.
That is cheating.
That's
how most women describe my sex. I confuse speed and depth. All right, heavy petting, the definition according to Google, what is it?
Erotic contact between two people involving stimulation of the genitals.
So I guess Lisa's right.
It's just a fancy word for manual stimulation.
All right, so heavy petting, cheating or not?
Yes.
Yes.
Even what you described in the elevator without going
But wait a minute, I'm confused now. Must the genitals be stimulated?
Would you rather somebody kiss your mate with tongue? Because we talked about kissing a second ago. 88% of women thought that was cheating. Or heavy pet your mate without kissing.
Kissing. Because the heavy petting is when you get in the sexual.
Women, 88.5% say kissing's cheating, and 88.5% consider heavy petting cheating.
Petting is much more cheating than kissing.
That's what
no,
I thought.
No,
I figured
see,
more
no,
women would
no,
think heavy petting
No, kissing, if I may quote Julia Roberts from Pretty Woman, I don't kiss on the lips. It's too personal. It's personal and intimate. You have to really want to kiss somebody.
So you'd rather, if you had your lady has to save the country by letting a guy kiss her on with tongue or heavy pet on her.
Heavy pet.
You'd let a guy go down her pants to save the country.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. I don't believe that.
Better than a kiss.
I know this is the most odd war we've ever fought. Still.
Yeah, I think kissing is a thing where someone could start to kiss you, and maybe you are attracted to them, and you start to respond, and then you stop. But if someone's getting in your pants, like, that isn't where you were taken aback and then, oh, yeah, I need to stop you. Like, you let them do that.
It's consensual.
So, to me, that's worse.
Right.
that's worse.
Unless it's something in the Cosby trial, it's consensual.
75% of men in America think heavy petting is cheating.
Yes.
So 25% are like, nah, whatever.
1 in 4 guys think I can go down your pants at a bar and then go home to my wife.
Oh, my, that's awful. That's insane.
What do you mean 12% of women think they can go down go give you a handy in the parking lot, then go home to their husband?
Awful. Awful. It's just not as
gotta love the deep south.
As far as Europe, gotta love Europe. 62% of men think heavy petting is cheating, and 72% of women think heavy petting is cheating.
So almost 4 in 10 say it's not really.
Wow. All right, before we get a quick look at traffic with Lisa, how about spooning?
That's pretty intimate, too. Unless you're
Are they
dying.
In a bed? Like, what happens?
We could be on a bed. Oh, we could be watching television. We're on the couch together. I'm just saying, it's spooning. We all know what spooning is. Big spoon, little spoon. So is spooning cheating? Think about it. Lisa's going to give us some traffic. What's going on, Lisa?
Traffic report is brought to you by Taco Bell. Sigler continues in the Malibu area. Canaan Doom Road, north of Pacific Coast Highway. Both lanes blocked because of an accident. At least a half hour to go on this, so look for delays there. On the 101, the Ventura Freeway eastbound at DeSoto, a wreck in the fast lane causing a backup for you. It stays busy, by the way, as you continue eastbound all the way into Studio City. 10 Freeway, the San Bernardino Freeway westbound on the Soto off-ramp, reports of an injury crash and a wreck on the 405 northbound at Seal Beach Boulevard in the carpool and the fast lane. When you've had a morning, let Taco Bell make it a little better with the new breakfast quesadilla. Fluffy eggs, crispy bacon, and melty cheese pressed inside a warm grilled tortilla. That's traffic on 95.5 KLOS.
Do you know absolutely nothing about the stock market? Well, good. That means you're the perfect student for Online Trading Academy. They're a brick-and-mortar school right here in Southern California that started over 20 years ago, and they're good. They're so good, they've expanded to 40 campuses around the globe, and they want to teach you. Maybe you're thinking, well, why do I need to learn this stuff? Well, for starters, you really want to be changed to your paycheck? Wouldn't it be nice if you had a skill set to make money on your own and not totally rely on that 9-to-5 that you may or may not like that much? And again, you don't need to know anything about the stock market. Online Trading Academy wants to teach you, and you can learn at your own pace and start trading for just a few hours a week on your smartphone or laptop. And they really do have an amazing community of people who want to support you every step of the way. So do what I did. Call my friends at Online Trading Academy. They have a patented course strategy that will help you learn to follow what Wall Street is doing and how to profit along with them. And that's whether the market goes up or down. And right now they're offering a free Wall Street Insider Kit so you can get started right away. Just call 888-991-TRADE. You're going to get 2 online classes, instructional videos, and a guide that will help you learn to build that second income. And they're going to throw in 2 free tickets to an upcoming workshop. So bring a friend and make money. 888-991-TRADE.
Lisa May has joined us. Before we get the news, Lisa,
Answer
the question, is spooning cheating?
Yeah, I think it is. Because what are these two people doing that they are in a position to be spooning to begin with?
70% of women in this country say spooning is cheating. 62% of men think it is. And in Europe, 44% of women think spooning is cheating, and 35% of men. So, I mean, they're over in Europe spooning each other all the time? I mean,
we've always known they were a lot looser when it comes to sex.
They're more touchy-feely than
you have somebody else. Maybe when you're single and a lot looser and trading it around, throwing it around, but when you have somebody in your life, when are you in a position to be spooning them?
You walk in and your husband's on the couch with another woman watching something on TV and they're spooning, you'd be like,
And what is the difference between spooning and cuddling, actually?
Spooning, the arms probably aren't caressing.
It's a specific position,
yeah,
right?
it's like spoons are not Friends hugging each other in the spoon drawer.
Cuddling, so cuddling's face-to-face?
No, not necessarily.
No, cuddling is your arms and legs would be over each other.
Well, no, I think cuddling could be you're laying on your back and maybe with your arms behind your head and I'm kind of laying and in your nook, in your pit.
So is cuddling cheating?
Yes.
Well, let's see. Cuddling. 67% of women in this country think cuddling is cheating. 62% of men. In Europe, 42% of women think it's cheating and 29% of men.
So you can just
get over here. Come on. If I was sitting over there on the couch and Sammy wanted to put her head in my shoulder, that's not cheating, is it?
Well, it's real awkward.
Cuddling her?
All of you picture coming home and catching your significant other, spooning or cuddling. You tell me you're not going to be upset?
Right. Sitting on the couch with
cheating?
Another woman.
Of course it is.
And she's cuddled.
It should be me. What are you doing?
Yeah,
unless you're freezing to death and the heat's off.
Is it only cheating because it seems like there's potential for sex? Because if I was cuddling Heidi, it wouldn't be cheating, right? She's over there, and I got my arm around her, and she's got her head on my shoulder.
Right. I have a gay friend that I would sit on the couch with. I mean, I don't know that we would cuddle, but if we did, it wouldn't be a big deal.
There you go. There's no potential for sex there.
So it's like you and your sister, or you and your gay friend, okay, but still it's on the road to being wrong.
The road to being wrong.
There's no road.
The Frosty Hyde.
You're at the intersection where the road forks off.
Is there going to be forking?
There's no forking.
There you go. That should be on the side of the RV. The road to wrong. On the road to wrong.
There we go.
Just driving down the street. All right, Lisa, what's going on in the world?
Hey, Money on the 20s coming up at 9:20. We want to congratulate Ruby Law from Chino Hills. She won yesterday. The keyword today is West Covina. So when you hear the cue to call, be caller 20 at 800-955-KLOS. Know that keyword and you will be qualified. News of the day is brought to you by USA Network. And we have our Subaru pet of the day. Danny is his name. He's very cute. A little poodle mix, white.
Frank, you better not let your lady see him. You'll
maybe
have
8 pounds.
I think that'd be a good buddy for Frosty's dog.
Yeah.
Both white.
Yeah.
A little mini me.
It's got kind of like the Founding Fathers powdered wig hair. Yeah. It's like John Adams.
George.
He's a little senior. He's 12 years old. He needs
why
a home.
Not? I'll take it. Okay, so
I got some disturbing pet news before you move on, Lisa.
What?
Yeah. A guy in California was just sentenced for killing 18 cats. Now, the good news is, the judge gave him the maximum sentence, 20 minutes in timeout.
Yeah. Frank Kramer!
No. It was 16 years. I was kidding.
Okay.
I believed him. Go to 95.5KLOS.com and check out Danny. Danny needs to go home with someone. Subaru Pet of the Day is brought to you by the all-new 2017 Subaru Impreza. It's more than a car. It is a Subaru.
Frank, does that cat killer have to divulge that when he applies for work? Just leave it alone.
You're hired.
Cats do not get a break. Jessica Alba is pregnant. She and her husband, Cash Warren, already have 2 daughters. Anna
Let's all
Marie.
Think about that for a second.
It's 9, yeah.
Jessica Alba.
There was some cuddling and some spooning.
Just
and
thinking about it is cheating. Haven Garner, her other daughter's 5 years old, made the announcement in an adorable video with her daughters holding up the balloons of red 1, 2, 3.
Aww.
So cute. Now we know why the Jim Henson Company fired Steve Whitmore. Now he's been doing, or Whitmire rather, he's been doing the voice of Kermit the Frog ever since Jim Henson died. And he went on social media last week complaining about the firing, saying he's willing to do whatever he needs to do to fix the issues, but the company's just not interested. Well, now the company's put out a statement. So Brian Henson, Jim Henson's son and chairman of the company, said they raised concerns about Steve's repeated unacceptable business conduct over a period of many years. He consistently failed to address the feedback, and he said Steve would send emails and letters attacking everyone, attacking the writing, attacking the director. And Lisa Henson, who's the president of the company, said Steve adamantly opposed having an understudy, but sometimes failed to show up for B-level performances like ribbon cutting, and then he blackballed young performers by refusing to appear on the show with them.
Well, that is a
so
problem.
That could be a problem. Yeah.
What would there be in the writing of Kermit to criticize? I mean, you're not, it's not Shakespeare.
I don't know what my motivation
is. It's Kermit the Frog.
I really don't understand this line here.
The Walking Dead has now resumed filming season 8. Last week, production shut down when a stuntman named John Benneker died after an accident on the set. Variety says he fell 20 feet off a balcony onto a concrete floor and that he tried to abort the jump, grabbed onto the balcony with both hands, but missed landing on a safety cushion by a few inches.
Oh,
yeah.
Jesus.
It was really bad. He suffered from a severe head injury. His family removed him from life support after donating his organs. Why are people so mean to Ed Sheeran? He's already gotten off Twitter. He did that after some followers made mean comments about his Glastonbury set, but now he's completely deleted his profile after his appearance on Game of Thrones, where people went after him big time. Someone tweeted, "When you think you're safe from Ed Sheeran, but he even weasels his way into the Seven Kingdoms of Westeros. And why does Ed Sheeran ruin everything I love? And nothing takes me out of a fantasy world like a random Ed Sheeran appearance."
Wow.
Tonight, Ryan Phillippe turns as Bob Lee Swagger in the USA hit original drama Shooter. The new season begins tonight at 10, 9 central, right after SmackDown Live on USA Network. And that's the news of the day.
When we come back, continuing this list of what is cheating, I guess we all have different opinions. Think about this one. Getting emotionally close. Whatever that might mean to you is getting emotionally close. Cheating. 1-800-955-KLOS is the number. Coming right back. We're Frosty, Heidi, and Frank.
Coming up on Frosty, Heidi, and Frank, brought to you by Pechanga Resort and Casino. Monday on the 20s is coming up at 9:20. The keyword today is West Covina. When you hear the cue to call, be caller 20 at 800-955-KLOS. Know the keyword and you'll be qualified. At Pechanga Resort and Casino, they invite you to win on another level with the world-class action of California's largest casino floor and over 4,000 slots. Whatever taking it to another level means to you, you'll find it at Pechanga Resort and Casino on another level.
Qualified households can get affordable home internet to make it easier to stay connected to friends, family, and the things that matter most with access from AT&T.
It's the latest Jerome's mattress innovation called the Jerome's Estate Copper Gel Mattress. I'm telling you about it because it's new and it's really cool. And anytime Jerry does something really cool, I, of course, want to pass it along to you. And the cool thing about this mattress is it's infused with real copper. What's that mean for you? Well, this copper gel foam is the most advanced gel memory foam on the market, which means you keep your sleeping temperature in the perfect zone, which is between 68 and 72 degrees. Not too hot, not too cold. No more tossing and turning during the night, waking up because you're too hot. It's also going to optimize and regulate your perfect sleeping temperature, give you more restful night's sleep. And to make it even more comfortable, Jerome, well, he went a step further and added natural latex foam, giving it just the right amount of support and bounce. The only downside of this mattress is you're not going to want to get out of bed. After sleeping on the Estate Copper Gel, it's going to be rough. Because it's that comfortable. And you're not going to find a lower price in town because Jerry uses his own branded mattresses that he designed from the ground up, better made than the expensive national labels. So check them out online at jeromes.com and see what I'm talking about.
Time Warner Cable Business Class is now Spectrum Business. And at Spectrum Business, the best keeps getting better. What does that mean for you? It means your business gets faster internet, more advanced voice, and over 99.9% network reliability. It also means no added taxes or fees, and no contracts, ever. Because at Spectrum Business, we believe in earning your business every day. Just call 866-928-4330 to get our new, faster internet speeds, up to 100 megabits per second. Now for only $44.99 a month. And that's not all. You can also add advanced business voice with unlimited long distance and over 30 calling features for just $29.99 a month. It's all part of our commitment to redefining what a cable company can be. Call 866-928-4330 today and switch to Spectrum Business to get new, faster internet and advanced voice for our best price ever. Restrictions apply. Call for details.
Hey, remember the mortgage meltdown of 2008? Have you tried to get a mortgage since then and been turned down? Or maybe you haven't even tried because your credit score is stuck at 585 or your tax returns have too many write-offs. Well, Cash Call Mortgage has great news for you. We've just introduced programs for people who've been told no. And what's doubly exciting is that we can solve your mortgage problems with no closing costs, no points, title, escrow, and no fees.
Wait, Cash Call, are you saying you now have credit and income-solving mortgages with no closing costs? Are you kidding?
You heard right. A credit or income-solving loan with no closing costs. Call 877-890-CASH, and we'll work with you to solve your mortgage issues. Make the cash call at 877-890-CASH.
Impact Mortgage Corp., DBA Cash Call Mortgage, Equal Housing Lender. Call 855-657-9910 for terms and restrictions. California Department of Business Oversight Residential Mortgage Lender Law License 4131083. NMLS 128231.
That's 877-890-CASH.
It's strong. It's peerless. It's imposing. It's bold. It's light. And it's delicious. Easy, Eagle. We're not talking about you. We are talking about Tecate Light, the light beer you are looking for. It's light, but full of flavor. And it's great with carne asada. Beef, not eagle meat. Tecate Light, born bold. Enjoy Tecate and Tecate Light responsibly. Copyrights 2017. Tecate Beer and Tecate Light Beer, imported by Cervezas Mexicanas, White Plains, New York.
The Ford summer sales event is in full swing.
The kids are not listening to me.
I got this. Who wants ice cream?
Oh, so that's how you get them to listen.
With available powerful third row seats in the Ford Explorer, there's always more room for the whole family. And then some.
Impressive, huh?
No, not really.
Wait, who are the two in the third row?
Take on summer right with Ford, America's best-selling brand, during the Ford Summer Sales Event. It's always a good time. Now with summer's hottest offer. Get 0% financing for 72 months on select Fusion, Escape, Mustang, and Explorer models. Plus, get $1,000 on top of your trade-in. Offer ends July 31st. Not all buyers qualify for Ford credit financing. 72 months at $1,389 per month for $1,000 finance regardless of down payment. Trade-ins as cash requires trade-in of 95 or newer vehicle or lease terminated 30 days prior to or 90 days after new retail delivery. Not available on Mustang Shelby GT350, GT350R. See dealer or go to buyfordnow.com for complete details. Take new retail delivery from dealer stock by July 31st, 2017.
You've got to try happy hour at El Torito. Experience their amazing food and drink specials for $4, $5, and $6. They've got tacos, garlic fries, carnita sliders, and spicy queso dip. Everything is made from scratch daily. That's right, from scratch daily. You can wash it all down with El Torito's signature margaritas and a full lineup of cold draft beer. The best happy hour in town starts at 3 p.m. every day, even on weekends. Experience happy hour at El Torito. We know Mexican.
Hey, it's Heidi. If you've been arrested for DUI, don't assume you have to plead guilty. Call the law offices of Top Gun DUI defense attorney Miles L. Berman. They know how to fight and win DUI cases in court and with the DMV. Take it from me. Let the team of experienced attorneys at the law offices of Top Gun DUI defense attorney Miles L. Berman represent you. Call 888-4-TOP-GUN. That's 888-4-TOP-GUN. Call 888-4-TOP-GUN because friends don't let friends plead guilty.
Sandman Well presents the new Rockin' Casino. We're changing the game with over 500 of the newest slot machines. And that means Sandman Well now offers over 4,700 slots, the most in California. The thrill just keeps on coming, so you'd better be ready to rock and discover a whole new kind of rush at our brand new Hurricane Bar, Tropical Storm. Come out and experience the new Rockin' Casino, only at Sandman Well. All thrill.
Must be 21 or older to enter casino. Please gamble responsibly. 1-800-GAMBLER.
At 7-Eleven, we're all about freedom. Like freedom to do the cotton candy taste bud twist with our cotton candy Slurpee, summer's newest sweet sensation. We like freedom so much, we're choosing to give this airplane middle seat 7.11 seconds of love.
The middle seat! Yes! Right in the middle of the action, surrounded by friends and elbows and just right in the middle.
Isn't love grand? Cool off at 7-Eleven and choose our brand new cotton candy Slurpee. But hurry, this offer is here for a limited time. Overthrow ordinary, only at 7-Eleven. At participating locations, see store for details.
If you suffer from fibromyalgia, you know how debilitating this disease can be. Every day is a struggle against widespread pain. Each year, 30 to 40% of fibromyalgia patients have to stop working or change jobs. CNS is a leader in clinical research and is now seeking volunteers for a new fibromyalgia clinical research study in your area. If you're 18 or older and have been diagnosed with fibromyalgia for at least 3 months, you may qualify to participate in this very important clinical research study. Qualified participants may be eligible for compensation for time and travel. Today's breakthroughs may become tomorrow's treatments. So take the next step and be a part of the search for a cure. If you or someone you know is interested in participating, contact CNS today at 844-714-3434 or visit them on the web at cnstrial.com/fibro. That's 844-714-3434. CNS, searching for a cure together. 844-714-3434.
We could all use a little more adventure in our lives. Whether that means biking down the face of a mountain, kite surfing, or just an amazing find at the farmer's market, we all define adventure a little differently. But no matter how you define it, there's a BMW SAV to get you there. From the superior handling and sleek design of the X3, to the luxury and unrelenting power of the X5, to the thrilling performance and versatility of the X1, there's a BMW SAV for every kind of journey. Plus, all BMW SAVs have more than enough cargo space for any outing. So, head to your local BMW center for exceptional offers through BMW Financial Services and define your own adventure in a BMW SAV. Even if it is at the local farmer's market. BMW, the ultimate driving machine.
Right now, lease the 2017 BMW X1 S-Drive 28i Special Edition for as low as $329 a month. Visit SoCalBMW.com today for details.
Go Casino Studios. It's Frosty, Heidi, and Frank on 95.5 KLOS and KLOS HD1.
Men and women reveal what they actually consider cheating to be. It's a wide range of like activities that people consider cheating. You would think vaginal intercourse would be 100%.
Cheating.
You know, that's just the ultimate of all cheating. No question, but in America, 99% of women and 97% of men believe it is. That means there are a few people out there who go, that's iffy. Maybe. I don't understand that, but there's like many. I mean, we've gone through vaginal intercourse, oral, anal, kissing, heavy petting, spooning, cuddling.
Stop, you're turning me on.
It's all cheating so far.
Jesus.
I'm just reading Sammy's to-do list. Now we're up to getting emotionally close. So... is getting emotionally close, whatever that is. I'm developing a relationship, non-sexual, just emotionally. We're telling each other secrets or texting each other, calling each other. How was your day? That type of thing. Is it cheating, Heidi?
I think so. And I mean, sometimes even more so an emotional relationship.
Interesting that you say that.
Sharing things.
Because cuddling... the last one we talked about, 67% of women in America said cuddling is cheating. But then getting emotionally close, 70% of women. So that means more women would rather you cuddle with a woman than let her know how your day was.
Right, because emotionally close could lead to feelings, deep feelings. Maybe cuddling or spooning or
How was it in Europe? Well, Europe, 46% of women said getting emotionally close is cheating. Going back to cuddling, 42% of European women. So once again, they'd rather you cuddle than talk to and get to know. How'd the men do? Well, 32% of men in Europe thought getting emotionally close is cheating, where cuddling was 29%. So men would rather you cuddle in Europe than get emotionally close. American men, 52.9% of men in America thought getting emotionally close was cheating. 62% thought cuddling was cheating. So everybody else, European men, European women, American women thought would rather you cuddle than get emotionally close, but not American men. We're like, no.
Can I just suggest that getting emotionally close is not healthy for your relationship, but is it cheating? I say no.
Oh, wow.
That
what's the asterisk for?
Because I always have an explanation for everything. No with an asterisk at the top. If you're emotionally close, that's fine, but it can't go any further than just being emotionally close. It can't be that plus... you hang out together and you spend time together and you do things that we as a couple should be doing, because if it takes anything away from our relationship, then that is on the road to cheating.
Well, it does automatically, because the emotionally close guy is, like I said, women are like monkeys when they swing from vine to vine. They don't let go of one vine to grab the other one. So they're holding on to the emotionally close guy for the moment that you mess up, and they're still, they can swing back with this guy.
Well, yeah, I get that. So, but I would like to believe, though, that see, the problem with, if you say you can't be emotionally close with anyone of the opposite sex, that would apply to me too, and that doesn't seem fair. You're denying me making some good, healthy relationships I might have.
You don't need a healthy relationship with a woman.
Let's say I'm married and Heidi and I are very close. Lisa and I get close. I'm close with Eric. These women, maybe even Sammy. But suddenly that's considered cheating? No, I don't think so. So you
I think it depends on what you're talking about. I think it depends. I mean, in 2017, it's probably a texting relationship. Maybe it's somebody at work, and then you start to share. Remember when you talk about work stuff, and then there's the sending emojis, and then there's the heart eyes, and the heart, and the kissy, and you, oh, I can't, the inside jokes between two people who work together.
Inside jokes are cheating.
Though. No, but I'm saying in getting emotional with somebody, and then you're sitting on the couch and texting, and it's like, who keeps texting you? We're watching a show, and you're like,
where it's taking away our time. That's infringing on our time.
And then you're like,
the only time an inside joke is cheating if it's a funny condom. Okay, we'll see. Moving on. Sleeping in the same bed. All right. This could happen. We go to events sometimes, and usually we have obviously separate rooms. Uh-huh. Oh, crap. There was a mistake
There's
in the
a
booking.
Mix up.
And Heidi and I have to share a room together, and it's a single queen.
Right. Don't worry about it. And by the way, if you worry about it and there's nothing to worry about, our relationship has problems. Because why are you suspecting that there'd be something going on? There's nothing going on. It's completely innocent.
And you also have to factor in, this has to be the bizarro, wacky world of, you know, you can't call down and get, can we get a cot? Can we get a rollout? There's no sofa in there. You know what I mean? Like, it's like, this is it.
Is the mistake that this is Frosty's room? Because he is a single queen.
Because it's funny, I'll keep my offense. under wraps because it was a damn good
it's
lie.
It's funny with an asterisk.
Yeah, I'll explain. They better have, yeah, the bed delivery service, the fold out. Right. That's fine, though. Sleeping in the same room, it's not in the same bed. Yeah. All right?
Listen, we know each other.
If it's a king bed, you can sleep way over there and I'll sleep way over here and there won't be any touching.
But still, 62% of women say sleeping in the same bed
really?
Is cheating. 51% of men, half of guys think, you know, you don't want your lady sleeping in the same hotel room, in the same bed, completely platonic.
Yeah.
It's cheating.
You build that pillow wall, baby. Just pillow wall.
Patrick said the way to decide if it's cheating or not, just picture your wife doing it, whatever this activity is, with a black guy. Would you let your wife sleep with Patrick in a hotel room in the same bed? Nothing happens. They just slept in the same bed. Is it cheating?
Boy, everyone's rethinking everything. It's like you've turned the game upside down.
There's so many tendrils branching off of this
one.
Yeah,
Frank, you're telling me if you go out of town, you go to Morongo, and for some reason I don't need to go, and you go, hey, go check on my lady. You live close by. Go check on her. And then it turns out that we ended up having a couple of drinks, and then I stayed in your bed with your lady.
There'd
Nothing
be no reason
happened.
To sleep in my bed because I have couches and I have other bedrooms.
Exactly. There would be no reason, but is it cheating? I think that's what this is asking.
The idea here is that there's one bed. If there's extra bedrooms and you sleep in my...
It doesn't say that in your questionnaire. It doesn't say there's a hotel mix-up and there's no cots
available.
There's
no other reason to be sleeping in the same bed.
Exactly, but here's why. We cheat. Nothing happened, Frank. I went and checked on your lady. We had some drinks and we accidentally passed out in the same bed.
What's your sleep number, Eric?
No, she lives at... You guys live
I get
out.
Home, it's like, wait, this is too soft. Somebody's been sleeping in my bed.
No, but I think in that scenario where it could feasibly be, work is you go over to check on her, and she's like, could you just stay? Like, there was
someone's been eating my porridge.
There was noises outside. You live in the hills. Like she could be scared. Like,
there's explanations
please,
you
please
can
don't,
give.
Please don't. Stay. Just stay with me. It's no big deal. Stay in the bedroom with me because I don't... I'm scared.
So did we cheat? Did your lady cheat on you?
No. This is the story of Goldilocks and the 3 inches.
Oh, he's being generous on your birthday.
I know, it's his birthday. All right, then let's see. Up to hand holding. It's holding hands.
Well,
I think as an adult, there's a certain age where holding hands just needs to stop.
It's awkward. Yeah.
Why would that happen if one of you is in a relationship? That should hop over sleeping in the same bed. You shouldn't be physically touching and holding hands.
I can't think of the last time There's I no held reason hands with somebody like that.
Oh, unless you're really upset, someone yelled at your work, you're crying, and I want to give you comfort and solace.
Well, then I would hug you.
We can hold a hand. Sometimes hugging is perceived as sexual assault these days.
now holding hands.
I think holding hands, that's the only way. If you're really upset about something and I briefly.
It's so intimate, though.
Would you rather I hug you or hold your hand? I mean, as far as feeling awkward. Come here. Holding your hand.
It's
what
just
did you
weird.
Do? You were...
No, but he does that weird, like, hey, tickle
with
his
finger
movement.
No, I wasn't tickling her palm. I was there. That was on the outside of her fingers. I was like, you know, just, I'm a hugger. I'm a hug hugger.
Yeah,
and
a rubber.
But you're
a
sexually
rubber.
Stroking her fingers in a sexual way.
Yeah, because you're showing me what you do with that thumb.
Yeah,
I know you.
Okay.
See, I know
no,
what you're doing.
No, I'm trying to get some stank off.
No,
somebody's been sleeping in separate bedrooms.
Hand-holding is so intimate. Like, even when somebody goes, all right, everybody, go ahead and grab hands with your neighbor. And it's awkward because it's supposed to be this intimate thing. So I think, yes, 100%
it's 52% of women in America think it's cheating. 46% of men do. In Europe, 33% of women think it's cheating. And 24% of men
you
think it's cheating.
You walk in and see
hands.
Your wife, your husband, sitting on a sofa holding hands with another person.
It depends
person.
On what
you're
like, talking about.
What?
Maybe the guy is saying, you know what? I have no sexual attraction to you whatsoever. You're in a great relationship with your husband. Good for him. Let's not meet anymore because I can't stand you.
But I walk in and I don't know and I'm like,
but
what?
I'm breaking it to you gently by holding your hand.
Now, Heidi started telling us a story off the air when we're, you know, obviously this cheating discussion wrapped around the commercial break. And she was starting to tell a story and I was like, nope, save it. If you like an example of, is it cheating? And
no.
So now go ahead and continue so we can all chime in.
Listen, I think the is it cheating? There was a situation where we were at my friend's house out in Simi Valley, a big pool party. It was a couple years ago. And we ended up doing the game of chicken, which you do. We're all boozing, drinking. And my lady got on the shoulders of this other girl who happened to be her ex-girlfriend who she lived with for 4.5 years.
Which direction is her ex-girlfriend facing?
It is relevant, isn't it?
So her ex is the bass man, and she's on the shoulders. And I wasn't even in the pool at the time. I was sitting off to the side.
Oh,
and,
my God. Well, you're not even in the pool?
No, I had gotten out. I was like sitting, whatever. I was sitting on the side, and they all decided to do that. And now,
how many people are in the pool at the time? You weren't there, but how many people? Was it just four people playing chicken?
No, there were six people.
All six people were playing chicken?
There were six people, and then there were a few of us that were just off on the side, just hanging out.
Has your lady dated everybody in the pool, so she would have gotten the shoulders of her ex no matter what? Or was there other women to choose from that she could have hopped on?
Oh, there are other women, yeah.
She chose her, okay.
Well, I don't know how, I don't know how it all played out. I don't know if they drew numbers out of a hat. I have no idea.
I'm sure, yeah, they got a hat.
Were they naked?
I probably,
what lesbian has a hat available?
Now that they're going to take off, this never leaves my head.
Was everyone clothed or were they naked?
No, there's like bikinis and stuff. You know, okay. Bikinis, and I think there was a board short or two in there.
But in chicken, there's contact. If you slide all the way up with your legs.
Naked gay chicken. This is not your house.
Stop it.
They're wearing bikinis, of course.
So, listen, this was a couple years ago. We've been together a long time. I know her ex really well. I love her. I get it. I get why they were together. I get why they're not together. And it didn't bother me. Now, if that had happened in the early stages of our relationship, I would have been pissed.
Oh, you'd put a big gash in the back of her head.
I would have laughed.
Ding that. I want a ding on that.
No, the drummer's still here. That's nice. He never stays this late. In the early stages of our relationship, I would have gotten pissed, and I would have said.
So you're at the point where you just don't care anymore.
No, it's not that. I know that relationship. There's no chance. You know what I mean? I know all the parties so well now that there's zero chance of that ever coming.
So I don't understand that. If she's been with her intimately in the past, there's always a chance.
No.
If you're at the point where you're playing chicken at a party, that means you've had enough to drink. Where chicken sounds like a good idea for a bunch of adult women. So
yeah,
I'm thinking, you're not even around.
I'm there. I'm just not in the pool.
The fact that she wants to get her nethers so close to this woman's face. She chose her to jump on. Could have picked any shoulders, any lady in the pool.
Yeah.
Says, me and Susan are going to team up.
Yeah. Right. It didn't bother me.
Didn't bother.
No, it didn't bother me. It's not that I don't care anymore. It's that what'd you ask earlier when you're like, is there a chance that would ever lead to?
So like going back to vaginal intercourse
and
these European women, 85% don't consider it cheating because they're like, oh, they don't care. I mean, like I said, early stages of the relationship, you'd have been like, no. Even though there was no chance back then either. But you cared back then. Now, if you don't care, it's like, oh, he can have his mistress. Vaginal intercourse all the time. It ain't cheating.
No, you said depending on who with. Now, if I went out there and she's on the shoulders of some new girl that I don't know, and what is going on here? Why are we doing this? I would be pissed. It depends on who it's with. Like you said, you and I in bed together.
Would you rather her be on the shoulders of a girl or be the bass girl and have a girl on the back of her neck?
I'd rather her be on the shoulders. Right? Yeah, right.
Because there is something there.
No, but
and it's better to be with an ex than a stranger.
Well, because I know the ex and I know there's zero happening.
By the way, this is in front of other people. It's not just the two of them, so there's
a game of chicken by yourselves.
I'm just saying.
Well, let's just kiss already. I mean, why are we trying to? We should do that.
I wouldn't be worried they're going to.
Shadow chicken sucks.
oh, dang it.
Like,
oh,
I don't have any friends that come over. I have to play it by myself. Two is like a crowd for me. Pool's closed. Capacity. So I'm just saying. The ones you worry about go off by themselves. They're in front of four or six other people. I wouldn't worry about that. But in a weird sort of way, it's almost a diss against you, isn't it? Isn't it kind of making you like, I mean, it's people, their eyebrows go up.
You go out there and she's on Patrick's shoulders.
It wouldn't bother me.
But
really? It takes a lot for a black guy to get in the pool. You know he's getting in because there's ulterior motives. He ain't swimming.
Well, he's in the shallow end, not a deep end.
Am I right, Patrick?
Can I get a what?
You're asking a black surfer if he has a problem getting in the pool.
I can't
ask a black surfer.
I really don't count. So.
Okay, he doesn't count.
He would have to have his 4-3 full wetsuit on in order for, you know, at about 3:45 in order for me not
but
to
you
be
see
upset.
It perk up when I mentioned shadow chicken?
Oh, my God.
He's like, now we're talking.
3:45 this afternoon.
1-800-955-5567. Okay, last one on this list of is it cheating or not? Okay. You're on a plane and the woman next to you falls asleep and you're masturbating. Is it cheating?
I don't think so. I don't think so.
Hands up or down on this one? What do you say?
I mean, it's creepy.
And it's in coach section. Coach section, so you're right next to each other.
It's in coach.
This actually happened, folks. It happened in the news. American Airlines. A woman. Now, here's the weird thing. This woman claims, her name is Chloe King, age 30. She's in her window seat. Masturbatory guy is next to her in the middle. There's another woman seated on the right side of this guy.
No, oh, jeez.
She claims that apparently she went to sleep in her window seat. The guy started pleasuring himself.
The other woman would be on the left, so she's on the aisle.
She's in the window.
The woman is asleep in the window. He's in the middle. Then the other woman's on his left.
Yes. Okay. Mm-hmm. Right. The aisle's whatever. I was on the left side of the plane. You're on the right side of the plane.
Wow, that's weird.
So the left.
Why
yes.
Why did we choose that?
No, weird.
Huh. Oh, I guess we have our preference.
I was picturing.
I thought next time I choose seats, I wonder if I always choose the right side of the plane.
You're more left, and I'm more right. I think that anyway. Huh. The point
is, I'm right-handed, so I figured it was more offensive. I was closer to her.
That's what I wanted to know too. I'm like, hopefully, it was right-handed, and it wasn't that offensive.
You used to right-handed, but I used to left.
Really? Why?
Why?
Because the right-handed is like someone else's.
Well, we have our preference.
Isn't that weird?
What? You're right-handed.
Yeah, I know.
He wants to feel awkward.
But I thought it was. I've never discussed this with anyone.
Look at me while doing it.
No, that only helps.
Remember the guy in the plane?
Oh, yeah.
The guy in the plane.
So there he is between the two women, and he's... Apparently the woman on beside him, not the window woman, but the aisle woman, complained. She got up and asked the stewardess, can I get a different seat?
Yeah. Stewardess, this guy's a bit of a jerk.
Today's menu, jerk whitefish.
You gonna eat those nuts?
I thought they only had warm nuts in first class.
So the flight attendant goes, oh, my God, well, certainly we can find another seat. There's another seat. So they moved her. She got to sit in another seat. The woman who's asleep wasn't woken up by the flight attendant. They let the guy continue to do his thing.
What?
With the woman sleeping next to her. Now, this became a problem to her, and she's all mad today because apparently when she woke up, the cops are waiting. When this is a transatlantic flight, so it's hours of this. Finally, the plane lands, and the stewardess comes up and talks to the woman and says, can you come with me? I want to talk to you. So the woman crawls over the guy, who's done by this point, and says, just want you
He's
to know.
He's asleep.
Just want you to know, when we land, the police are going to board the plane and take this man off. He was doing something during the flight. What was he doing? Well, he was masturbating. And she goes, you didn't tell me? You left me there? Well, you were sleeping. Oh, it gets worse. They go, now, ma'am, you need to return to your seat till we land.
And he's still sitting.
So she had to crawl over the guy.
Oh, no, no.
And sit back in her seat there in silence, knowing what he'd done.
No, I'd taken the flight attendant's jump seat, and she can go sit next to that dude. No way.
So she's all upset and says it's wrong on so many counts. They didn't tell her, blah, 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 blah.
God.
You think American Airlines screwed up on that?
United's like, yes! Yes!
So's Delta. Like, oh my God, thank God.
It finally. Wasn't us. Yeah. It wasn't us.
Thank God it's not Ann Coulter.
Aww.
Oh, look, it's here. Let's turn these things on. Hello.
Happy
it's Keith.
Keith the boss.
To oh, the whole game.
Dawn.
Happy birthday to Marcia. You. Happy birthday, dear Eric.
Aww.
Happy birthday.
They like me. They really
they
like
do
me.
Like you. You got a cake and everything.
Oh, thank you,
guys. What's the cake
guys.
Say?
Oh, what's it say, Keith? You get to keep your job.
Oh, yay! So,
it was a last-minute grocery store thing. They didn't have time to put anything on.
Oh, but, that's so nice.
Was that going to be your wish, Eric? You can be honest.
Yes, it actually was. Just make it till next year. That's what I keep telling myself.
My God, is that the show already?
Time flies.
Had so much fun. Thank you all for stopping by.
Thank
we'll
you
see
guys.
You later in the big
Thank
meeting.
You.
Yeah, big meeting later.
Oh, happy birthday, Eric.
Hugs.
Is that cheating? Look at that hug. You mean contact.
That was
spooning.
We're going to tell your wife.
What is this, American Airlines? Cut that out.
Yeah.
All right, we do have to apologize to those of you that we have offended today. Can't imagine. Oh, also, it's money on the 20s. So give us a call. Be the 20th caller at 800-955-KLOS. Tell us today's keyword, and you'll score a $25 gift card to Del Taco. Juicy pork carnitas are back. Then the $500 could be yours later today when Gary Moore calls the winning name at 520. So keep it here all day long on the Rock of Southern California, 95.5 KLOS. Let's say sorry.
Sorry to American Airlines, where that aisle seat can't be beat. Kissy grandmas, European cheaters, and whoever else you want to put in there.
Des Moines, Iowa, I'll put them in there. Ed Sheeran, pawn shops and dildo thieves.
Baby Rabbits, the Armstrongs, R. Kelly, and Runaround Sue.
Convicted felons, Radio Shack, Katy Perry, Barry Manilow, and ABBA.
Nannies, Rob Kardashian, Cinnabon, and Ricky Skaggs.
Former lesbians, fat girls, KBC, and the DWP.
O.J. Simpson, the Invisible Man, river dancers, and bank tellers.
Heavy petters, Bill Clinton, Kermit the Frog, and lesbian chicken fighters.
Spooners, Rihanna, Single Queens, and Goldilocks. You really have to listen to the whole show. We are Frosty, Heidi, and Frank.
Sports on Tap. On the Rock of Southern California, 95.5 KLOS.
Lakers win the NBA Summer League title, beating Portland 110-98. Woohoo! Hang a banner in Staples. Lonzo also named the MVP of Summer League in spite of not playing last night. Baseball, it's Kershaw Day on the South Side as the Dodgers look for 10 in a row as they face the White Sox. And in Anaheim, Angels back in action with the Nats in town. Mike Trout back on the field, and tonight is Mike Trout bobblehead night. I'm Pete Fox at Sports on Tap on the Rock of Southern California, 95.5 KLOS.